Days in Georgia, presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia, buckle up. We've got a semifinal doubleheader for you this evening from Lakewood Stadium in Atlanta. We start with the 7A semifinal as the number 5 Mill Creek Hawks take on the number 8 Milton Eagles. And good evening. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former Auburn Tigers All-American, NFL first-round draft pick, and 15-year pro Wayne Gandy. And Wayne, Mill Creek trying to get to the state championship game for the first time in program history. Milton trying to get there for the second straight year. This is the third time in 5 years these two teams have played in the playoffs. Milton has knocked them out both times. Could it be a little bit of a salty game tonight?
A little rivalry just to get this whole big semifinal going tonight. Two teams who really feel like they are built to take home that trophy next week.
Let's talk about Mill Creek. Probably the most talented team they've ever had. They're 12-1. They've won 6 in a row since their one and only loss to 3-time state champion Buford. It all starts with Caleb Downs. He's the number 1 prospect in Georgia. He's the number 1 safety in the nation. Number 11 overall prospect in the nation. And he's committed to Alabama.
So you're saying he's good?
Yes.
Mr. Fantastic right here is Caleb Downs, the 5-star, 6'2", 195, dynamic at running back, big play receiver down the field, and we really just haven't found anything defensively this young man cannot do. He is a problem, and he's an outstanding player.
Beauty of high school football is you go from 5-star to no star. Cam Robinson does not have any recruiting stars, but he's been one of their biggest stars in the playoffs.
Moved from the slot to the running back position early in the season, 1,450 yards, 18 touchdowns. He's been able to produce great vision, great speed, and the thing you love about him, he's tough running between the tackles.
Defensive side of the ball, their defensive end, Nick Maxey, another no-star guy, but he has been big in the playoffs for the Hawks.
6'4", 210, long, rangy defensive end. Just one of those guys that can create havoc in the backfield, rushing the passer. And the thing tonight, his tight end ability might be the key to how they get this victory.
All right, let's talk about Milton. They were left for dead when they lost 3 of their first 5 games. They were 2-3 at the halfway point of the regular season. But they've won 8 in a row, including knocking out Grayson in the quarterfinals last week. And their sophomore quarterback, Luke Nichol, is really becoming a star. He's been offered by Florida State. He's been offered by Michigan State. He's going to be a big-time quarterback in the next few years.
The gamer. He is 6'2". He's 200 pounds. He's cool. He's collective. He's very mature. Sometimes you forget he's a sophomore, dual threat, gritty with a big arm. The thing tonight, he only has 8 interceptions. He's going to need to keep that at 8 tonight against this defense.
He's got a big-time target in 4-star wide receiver DeBron Gatling, who has exploded in the playoffs. He's got 42 offers.
Deep threat down the field, one of those wow factor kind of players, elusive with the ball in his hands, great at cornerback. Last week, scored a touchdown, interception from a touchdown on the defensive side, offensive reception for a touchdown, Mr. Both Ways.
Speaking of the defensive side of the ball, their defensive end, Owen Phillips, another no-star guy, has been an absolute monster on defense this season.
Those numbers are just video games. 15 and a half sacks, 25 and a half tackles for loss. This young man inside, make him an offer, Matt. He is very disruptive, strong, physical, and has a high motor leading this 54 sack defense of when you look at Milton.
Yeah, hopefully somebody is going to make Owen Phillips an offer before it's all said and done. So the winner goes to the state championship game next Saturday, right down the road at Center Park Stadium on the campus of Georgia State University. The third member of our team is Autumn Johnson. She's standing by at Lakewood. Happy December, Autumn.
Matt, these guys have been competing underneath the Friday night lights all season long, starting at 7:30 p.m. Eastern. Different story this time around, starting at 5 p.m. That shakes things up when you think about pregame routine and also consistency. In fact, both of these squads had to start their day around 11:30 a.m. Eastern so they can go ahead and get lunch, leave school early, and get ready to go. For Mill Creek, they went out to Stockbridge, and then for Milton, they went to Georgia Tech. And they came here to Lakewood Stadium around 2:30 to get pre-taped, dressed, and ready to go. But despite all the changes, adjustments, the message stayed clear. For Mill Creek, Love Lady said to his team to control what you control, worry about the X's and O's. As far as Milton, Coach Reeves told his squad that every situation can be viewed as an obstacle or an opportunity. Take this one as an opportunity. Adapting and adjusting will be key tonight. Let's go ahead and head up to Hannah in the studio.
Thanks, Autumn. December means GHSA semifinal time, and 32 teams are in action. We'll narrow that down to the final 16 tonight. We've got a doubleheader on deck for you. This game will be followed up by the 6A matchup between Rome and Langston Hughes. Kickoff is set for 8 p.m. John, I'm looking forward to both games at Lakewood Stadium and breaking down who's in and who's out with you on the halftime shows. But first, we got to get through Mill Creek versus Milton. Let's take a look at those brackets.
No doubt about it. Let's take a peek at 7A and show you how things have gotten to this particular moment in time. This is the right-hand side of the bracket. As you have followed along in pen, winner of this one gets the winner of Colquitt County and Carrollton. That one is down at the Hog Pen in Moultrie at 7:30. The paths for both of these teams that you're going to see here on GPB: Mill Creek beat Meadow Creek, beat North Cobb, beat Westlake to get to Lakewood. Milton, low right, beat Cherokee. Then they beat Norcross, held Grayson to only 12 points last week in their 35-12 win. And that's how we ended up with these two teams on the right-hand side, one win away from Center Park. So, Matt, if you would please go ahead and light the blowtorch and tell the rest of the state to buckle up, because it is semi-final Friday.
Indeed, it is time to buckle up. And for those watching at home, here's your chance to participate. You can go to the QR code on your screen and pick the winner of tonight's game. So Milton is kicking off. We'll see Mill Creek on offense to start this game. And the opening kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seatbelts save lives. Felipe Mota has it teed up and ready to kick off. Rather unusual lineup here for the kickoff for the Eagles, and Mota will kick it deep, coming down at the 1 yard line, so this is returnable. Mikhail Wood across the 30, still on his feet on a cutback, weaving his way through the defense, finally dropped at the 36 yard line. That's a 35 yard return and a great start for the Mill Creek Hawks at 12-1 on the season, 4-1 in Region 8-7A, and a number 2 seed. They are 5-1 on the road this season. And there you see their quarterback, Wayne. Hayden Clark, three-year starter, has completed 59% of his passes. It's been offered by Washburn and Reinhardt.
Great season he's put together, especially with the contribution of Cam Robinson. Has taken a little weight off him, but he has great receivers and Jenkins, Woods, and Downs. Watch for him to try to get going early down the field.
You saw his career numbers, nearly 5,000 yards passing. Handoff goes to Cam Robinson on the first play of the game, and Robinson's going to pick up a couple of yards on the play up to the 38-yard line. Let's take a look at the Regions Bank starting lineup for the Hawks on offense. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. Murphy, Sheen, Marshall, Banfield, who's their bell cow, and Bothwell up front. The running backs, Downs and Robinson, with Jenkins, Wood, and Mullins, the tight ends and the receivers. Handoff goes to Cam Robinson again, and he moves the pile up to the 46-yard line, and that's going to be a first down or close to it. 8-yard pickup for Cam Robinson.
Great jump cut right there by Cam Robinson. Parton, the middle linebacker, has him dead to right in the holes, but nice shiftiness by him. He's one of those guys, as we talked about just a minute ago, Matt, that is very strong running the ball within that box.
So first and 10, he did pick up the first down. Fresh set of downs for the Hawks at the 46-yard line. Clark goes to the air, and it's caught by Wood. 25-20, touchdown, Mikhail Wood, and Mill Creek goes for 54 yards.
Mikhail Wood has just dominated this season in his senior year. Big play down the field. Great playoffs, nice find, good protection holding up front. Beautiful ball here by Clark, leading the receiver. And when a guy like Woods gets the ball behind you, he is known for their deep threat. Touchdown, Mill Creek.
Jacob Ulrich is on for the PAT. The holder is Trajan Greco. The snapper, Braden Walters. And a 7-0 lead for Mill Creek as they score in 1 minute and 19 seconds. Great start for head coach Josh Lovelady and his team. Clark with his 23rd touchdown pass of the season, and the Hawks have the early lead.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your eyes, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
DVHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Present our $1,500 donation from our friends at Cigna to our friends here at Milton High School. And I'm joined by the athletic director, Gary Silvestri. Thank you so much for being a friend to Friday Football Nights and also GPB all season long.
Thank you for having us. We're excited to be here, and we appreciate all you guys do for us.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the game. Thank you, guys. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Autumn. What a start for Mill Creek. The 54-yard touchdown pass from Clark to Wood, and Wood now over 900 yards receiving this season. He's at 926, but a big-time play, Wayne, right out the gate as you take a look at the scoring drive, the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign scoring drive. Three plays, 64 yards.
Just one of those guys, Mikael Wood. You can't let him get behind the defense. Got to keep him in front of you. And a beautiful pass there by Hayden Clark down the field to get this game going.
6'1", 150. That's the only thing that keeps Mikael Wood from being a power five wide receiver. Kick is coming down in the end zone. So Mill Creek, their first offensive possession is going to start at the 20-yard line. Ben Reeves, been a busy week for him. Autumn Johnson will have more on that as we go throughout the game tonight. But in his first season, a lot of doubters of Milton as they started the season 2-3, but they finally figured it out. Played a lot of tough teams right off the top, and now they are 10-3 on the season.
And those early losses, in his estimations, Coach Reeves galvanized his team. It's what gelled them together. They were playing tough teams, as you said, Matt, lost some early games, but the way they rebound has kind of been their signature, a resilient team all around.
Luke Nickel this season right at 2,400 yards passing, 22 touchdowns, just 8 interceptions. They're going to go to the air on the first play. He was hit as he throws. It's going to fall incomplete at the 33-yard line. But we take a look at the Milton offense. It's brought to you by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. Up front, they go Zapata, Heineke, Bonatti, Phillips rushing, and Schindler. The running back is Moskowitz, and the receivers are Gatling, Esley, and Nave. G is the tight end. He's going to be a big-time tight end in the years to come, just a sophomore with 12 offers. Second down and 10. Moskowitz gets the carry. He's got a first down and more across the 40. Moskowitz off to the races. Caleb Downs chases him down at the 30-yard line. He comes away with the football, but I think they're going to rule him down by contact at the 29.
Great blocking here on the left side of the line. Zone blocking. Nice find by Moskowitz right there. And it takes Caleb Downs and his kind of speed to be able to run him down. A good job starting off, good blocking. Nice job getting to the second level there by Evan Zapata, the left tackle. Not known for his speed, but showing you enough speed right there to get those big chunks of yards is Moskowitz.
That was a 51-yard run by Moskowitz, who goes over 1,100 yards rushing for the season with that first run of the game. Play action. Nickel going for the end zone, and Esley cannot bring it in the corner of the end zone.
Nice Ball right here. Great route, too, by Astley, giving the quarterback room to drop this ball in. Kept it away from the sideline. Good protection up front. And just not able to come up with the tough catch right there. Defender getting his hand in there. Jaden Patterson at the last moment, you can see, stuck that left hand in there and knocked that ball away.
Esley has been their number two receiver this season. 53 catches, that would lead a lot of teams.
A little undersized is Esley, but other than that, he is a big contributor to this offense.
Going to swing the ball out here to Thornton. And Bryce Thornton, the commitment to Florida, who starts at safety, is knocked out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. Regents Bank starters for the Hawks on defense. Nick Maxey, we talked about. Ankrum and Denick joining up front. The linebacker core, A.G., Jamal Anderson, four-star going to Clemson, Mullins and Anglin. And in the secondary, Greco, Content, Downs, and Patterson. Downs, of course, gets a lot of publicity. Patterson's pretty good, too.
This is a great secondary. These two corners have come along this year, and Greco and Content to round this secondary off, and they are just tough to throw against.
Third down and eight. Nickel trying to drop it in there for Gatling. A battle for it, and it's broken up by Greco. I tell you what, Greco has really come on in the playoffs. Had two big interceptions last week against Wesley.
All-County basketball player finally really getting into football. Nice job of timing. Didn't get his head around to find the ball, but you could see his timing right here, waiting to, on the receiver to show him the ball is there, getting both hands in there to knock it away, Trajan Greco.
So they're going to try a field goal here. They've got Mota on for a 44-yard attempt. Trouble, the punter, is the holder, and the kick is going to be blocked. It's out there for a scoop opportunity for Mill Creek, and it's still rolling around, but the Hawks are going to have it on the other side of the 50.
Big time pressure off of that right edge for the block. The ball never really got off the ground. Right here, you can see decent snap. A lot of white jerseys in there. Really can't tell who got their hand on it. You see 13, Jaden Patterson, with a wall of Mill Creek defenders in the backfield. Big penetration up the middle. Fortunate right there for Milton. They were not able to scoop that ball and score a touchdown.
It looks like it might have been number 75, Bryce Bothwell, coming right up the middle. One of the Bothwell twins. Looks like he's the guy who blocked that field goal. And the Hawks take over at the 45-yard line of Milton. Cam Robinson going to pick up a tough 3 yards right there as Will Parton, the linebacker, makes the stop for the Eagles. And here's a look at the Regents Bank starters for the Eagles. They go Smalley, Spencer, and Phillips, who we talked about up front. The linebacking core is just phenomenal numbers. Moran, Parton, Lawson, and Stewart. Stewart just picked up an offer from Ole Miss this week, his first collegiate offer. Best safety combo in the state, perhaps, with Billings and Thornton. You got Lewis and Holmes at the corners. All four of those guys have Power 5 offers. Clark throws. It's complete to Caleb Downs. First touch of the game for Caleb Downs as we take a look at the Breda Pest Management keys to the game.
Win the line of scrimmage. That's the big key here for this Milton offense. If they can give Hayden Clark time, as we saw in that early first drive, they can light up the scoreboard in Milton. They cannot let Cam Robinson break tackles. They got to be able to hit him and get him down on the ground. Milton, this defense has to focus on their tackling.
Breda Pest Management, official pest control of high school football. It's third down, and let's call it two from the 37.
Cole Mullins right here. Watch the tight end. And these kind of plays, they like to find him.
Handoff goes. Caleb Downs has the first down, trying to shuck a tackle, but I think he got enough for the first down. That was Will Parton again driving him out of bounds, but I think his forward momentum crossed the line to gain.
Caleb Down, this is when he makes his money. Short yardage, goal line situations. You can see the juke, the shiftiness in the hips. And you can see the size. He's a big safety. Plays physical. Not sure They gave it to him. Looked like maybe.
Oh, they're going to rule it short. I thought he got his body across the 35, but they have spotted it at the 36. So it's fourth and one.
And you saw him get the first down, but then kind of take himself back. And maybe that's what they counted, that he kind of ran back trying to make extra yardage.
Fourth and one. They run up to the line of scrimmage. The quarterback sneak by Clark, and that does get the first down. Gets more than the first down, all the way down to the 21-yard line. Hayden Clark.
Big push in the back there by Cam Robinson, Caleb Downs. You see this play now consistently where the running back, fullbacks, tight ends get directly behind the quarterback, start shoving him right here. I think Milton, that Eagles defense kind of lost who they were tackling. So many bodies pushing the ball, kind of lost to Hayden Clark.
He ended up getting 15 yards on that fourth and one play. You see his rushing numbers over 6 yards per carry this season. Going to whip it out here, and Robinson can't come up with it. And then Parton collides with him at the 23, and everybody looks like they're going to be okay.
Pressure off the edge there by Ja'Cory Stewart, number 18, just trying to get the ball outside to Cam Robinson in the open field. Took his eyes off the ball right there.
Fourth season as the head coach of the Hawks. He's been in the program since 2004. He had joined the original coach, Shannon Jarvis, on the first ever coaching staff at the school. So he's been there 19 years and trying to get him to the state championship game for the first time ever. Cam Robinson, there's Will Parton again. Will Parton has been a tackling machine this season. 131 tackles for Will Parton, 13 TFL, 10 quarterback sacks.
Just a warrior inside. Great size at 6 feet, 215. Tough-minded, as coach talked about. Just one of those guys always around the ball is Parton.
Third down and 8.
Trying to get him to jump off sides right there, resetting the defense. A lot of bodies inside. And you look, playing a little soft zone on the back end.
Got a full box right there. Delay a game penalty. They beat the delay a game with the timeout.
Timeout. Mill Creek.
So Mill Creek does not take the penalty there. They get the timeout called in time. Let's take a look at the Mill Creek Hawks and their resume. This is their third semifinal appearance in program history. Got there undefeated in 2015 and 2016, beaten by Colquitt County and Grayson, the eventual state champions in both of those years. Made the playoffs 9 straight seasons, quarterfinals in 2019, last year in 2021. And yeah, guess who beat them last year in the quarters? It was this Milton team. And they've won 2 region championships in program history.
And it's early on in this game right now, Matt, but you feel like this is a big stop for Milton. You really feel like this defense has to get off the field. They cannot let Mill Creek convert this and keep this drive going. We saw before the timeout, a lot of bodies. This defense came up with 54 sacks so far in the season, so they bring pressure, especially with those linebackers.
So third down coming up. It's 3rd and 8. And this is the 7th play of the drive coming up. Mill Creek offense averaging over 45 points per game this season. They've rolled up 214 yards rushing per game, 173 passing, 387 total yards per game. That's a strong number for a high school football team. Remember, they play 48 minutes, not 60. It's 3rd down and 8. Downs in motion. Clark looks his way, goes the other way now. Got a man open, and Wood got his feet down for the touchdown. Mikael Wood with his 2nd touchdown in the first 6 minutes of the game, and Mill Creek on top 13-0.
And it all starts with the protection. We talked about it as one of the keys. If they can win the line of scrimmage, what a clean pocket here for Hayden Clark to survey the field, step into the throw, and deliver this touchdown to Woods, who once again gets behind this defense. And this talented secondary cannot continue to allow that kind of player into the secondary.
Ulrich with the PAT, and it is 14-0. What a start for Mill Creek and Josh Lovelady's Hawks. And Mikel Wood just keeps lighting it up.
Protection up front, nice job there by Cole Mullen staying in. Look at the delivery of this ball here on Braden Holmes, the corner. As we talked about, can't really get a better secondary, and nice drop and throw, good route. Great concentration, keeping both feet in there by Mikael Wood for the touchdown.
Mikael Wood, ESPN three-star wide receiver, committed to Eastern Michigan. Over four other offers, including Georgia Southern. Already has two touchdown receptions tonight and 17 total touchdowns on the season. And Wayne, Eastern Michigan, National Signing Day can't get here soon enough for them, because the more Mikael Wood is on television playing like this, the greater the opportunity somebody's going to come along and make another offer.
And as you alluded to, only thing that keeps him from maybe the Power Five is a couple of inches in height. He has big game, and you're right, Matt, the way he is showing right now and the eyes that are going to be on this semifinal game and the final game, if they make it, he definitely could find himself somewhere else.
Nothing against Eastern Michigan. So ball goes into the end zone. Ball will come out to the 20 for Milton. And let's take a look at the Breda Pest Management keys to the game when the Milton Eagles are on offense.
Locate and contain Caleb Downs. When he's down in the box, you got to get a hat on him in the run game. And as a quarterback, you got to make sure you're safe with the ball when throwing his way. And for Mill Creek in this defense, they like to do a lot of shifts. Milton does shifts, motions to try to confuse you. You got to get lined up. You got to know your assignment. Don't let them beat you with mental errors.
So first and 10, now the Eagles' second possession. They're already down two touchdowns. Pass completion to DeBron Gatling. First catch of the game for Gatling. And locating Caleb Downs, that's really in every aspect of the game, on offense, on defense, and special teams, right?
He's just one of those guys that can make plays from all levels of the field. It's Caleb Downs, and you can see right here on this series of downs, got to get the ball, got to get DeBron Gatling going, find ways to put the ball in number one's hand at any time and as often as you can.
Second down and four. Moskowitz going to get dropped for a loss back at the 21-yard line.
Big pressure there by Devin Akram, number 72, pushing his way back. This defense in all three levels. We talk about Caleb Downs, but they have players. You know, sometimes we get lost with the Andersons, but Maxie and Denick, Anglin, they have a lot of players on this defense.
They absolutely do. You see Jamal Anderson, number one, creeping up there, coming on a blitz. He's coming from the outside. Nickel goes to the outside, incomplete at the 43-yard line. Patterson had tight coverage on Esley, and now it's going to be a punting situation for the Eagles.
Jaden Patterson, definitely a unique player, 6'3 safety. When you look at that, that's not typically safeties kind of max out at that 6'1, 6'2, but at 6'3 junior, long, a track guy, it's going to be hard to outrun him. Not sure if that's where he will stay at the next level, but he has that big body, big frame, and hard to throw over.
Caleb Downs standing deep for the Chase Trouble punt. Trouble's been good, but he's been hurt. He just came back last week, averaging 42 yards per punt this season. Another bomb off of his foot. Downs fields at the 38. One man misses, trying to get to an edge and cannot, get dragged down at the 38-yard line. And that's where Mill Creek will go on offense, once again leading 14-0 at Lakewood Stadium.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being. Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at ExpressGA.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Let me know if I can help you with anything. Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
That's a polyester fiber made of oil.
By the way, where's your dressing room?
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Stadium, and what a week for Coach Reeves for Milton. He's coaching in the semifinals today, but just 5 days ago, his second child was born, Riley Michael Reeves. 21 inches, 8 pounds, 14 ounces, and just a bundle of cuteness. Coach Reeves put out a tweet saying everyone is healthy, happy, and he will begin quarterback training later this week. Coach Reeves joked that hopefully his kids can give him some job security for being so good at the game, and Riley will definitely be one of my top prospects to watch out for in 2036, you guys.
Yeah, thank you, Autumn, for sharing that glorious news. And Wayne, make that kid an offer.
Definitely already got the height at 21 inches. He's coming in.
Mill Creek goes on offense from the 38-yard line. Call it the 39 instead. Cam Robinson going to get another carry. And Robinson violently tackled at the 44-yard line.
You get the sense that maybe this Milton defense on the back end might be in a little shock. When you talk about the names in that secondary of Thornton, Billings, Holmes, Lewis, and those guys, I don't think they felt like Milton was just going to come in here and go down the field. I think they thought they was going to get a heavy dose of Cam Robinson, which they definitely are going to get that. But the challenging Hayden Clark down the field so far with Mikael Wood has been fantastic.
Yeah, Cam Robinson, what a story he has been for the Hawks this season. Second down and four, ball at the 45. Play action, Clark going for the home run again. Is it there again? And what a catch over the shoulder. Mikael Wood absolutely putting on a show here in the first quarter.
And right now, Mikael Wood and Hayden Clark, they see that one-on-one matchup, and so far in this game, it's been against Braden Holmes, number 21. What a drop in the bucket. What focus there to bring that ball down by that young man.
39-yard catch. He has over 100 yards of receiving already here in the first quarter and threatening to blow Milton out in the first 12 minutes of the game.
Very explosive, showing another page to this offense. It seems to have this defense rattled right now.
Clark going to swing it out here to Cole Mullins, the tight end. Big fella dragged down at the 10-yard line. He's another nice prospect, been offered by Wake Forest, Duke, and Vanderbilt.
6'5", about 235, only a junior. Big body, great block. That's the thing you love about him. Will he commit to blocking when you have that kind of talent? And that's what he does. He's a great blocker inside. All-state baseball?
Yeah.
As well.
I was going to say, Willie, when you said commit to blocking, I'm like, will he commit to football? Because he might play baseball. He's a big-time baseball prospect as well. Great to have options. Second down and four. Play action here. Scramble out by Clark, gets a stiff arm inside the 10, and Hayden Clark gonna sneak inside the pylon for the Hawks' third touchdown of the night.
Great job of deciding to pull this ball. Milton defense read this play. Hayden Clark showing that high 4.5 speed. Sometimes you look at him, you don't think he has that explosiveness, but he has some little wheels in him, as he showed you on that play. Showed you the strength as well with the stiff arm. And at this moment, all you can say about this Mill Creek offense is wow.
21-0 as Ulrich puts it in the uprights.
Watch all the black jerseys that go with Caleb Downs inside, pulling the ball out, running Wyatt Smalley, which is not an easy task to get to the edge right there. And then the stiff arm. He's in a true groove. Make a couple big touchdowns down the field. This is the kind of energy it provides to get in for the touchdown there. It's Clark.
Yeah, he's been offered by Washburn and Reinhardt. Reinhardt, an NAIA program, a top 10 NAIA program. As you take a look at the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign scoring drive, four plays, 61 yards. The big play, the 39-yard pass to Mikael Woods. But he's such a smart quarterback, three-year starter. Should take a look at Mill Creek and what Hayden Clark has led offensively for this team. An offense over 45 points per game, 40-plus in 10 of their 13 games. They've beaten nine playoff teams. They've had three shutouts on defense, and their only loss to number one Buford, who is no longer in the playoff field, got upset by Walton in the second round. Ulrich, who is just an absolute special teams weapon. Esley on the return. Going to get stopped shy of the 20-yard line. Knocked out of bounds at the 19.
Nice coverage there by the coverage team of Mill Creek. Along with a little fake action was Mark Esley, but kept the ball. Nice job of the coverage team of staying in their lane and not letting him get up the field.
Be sure to watch us next week. Of course, the state finals, eight state championships games. We'll also reveal our GPB All-State team next week. Some of the guys you're watching here tonight, both sides of the ball, will be represented on that team. It's a tough choice. We got some five stars. We got some no stars. We got players from all over the state. Handoff goes to Moskowitz. Moskowitz, who's a bull, gets up to the 23-yard line. Four-yard pickup for Moskowitz.
Good tackle there by Josh Anglin, number 26. What a player he is, the leading tackler on this defense. Kind of get overshadowed with the names like Anderson and Downs, but what a heck of a player. 6 feet, 212, junior. It's one of those guys that can get downhill quickly and make tackles.
Josh Lovelady says he reminds him of Rennie Curran, who played at rival Brookwood when Coach Lovelady was at South Gwinnett. Moskowitz trying to move the pile. There's Anglin on top of that tackle again.
Anglin, a nice job there of hustling, rallying to the ball by Jamal Anderson as well. Forcing the handoff right there of Nickel and then getting back into the play to bring down Moskowitz.
Third down and five. Jamal Anderson committed to Clemson, four-star linebacker rated by On3 Recruiting, the number nine linebacker in the country.
Showing pressure. There's Anderson coming off the edge.
Luke Nickel fires, and it's broken up by Greco again. You mentioned Greco's a big-time basketball player. He keeps playing like this. He's going to be a football player in college.
Just has grown up this season. You can see him always has hands. He's all tight coverage, always sticking that hand in there to knock the ball down. Pleasant surprise for this defense. Really kind of rounded out this secondary with his performance this year.
Another punting situation. Trouble on the kick. He had a 41-yard kick his first time. And Caleb Downs is standing deep, and it's going to go out of bounds at the 39.5. So that's where the Hawks go on offense. That was a 36-yard kick. And Ben Reeves' team in some trouble here. Down three touchdowns with a minute and 12 seconds left in the first quarter.
Hayden Clark, Mikael Wood have put on a show in this first quarter. The secondary, as talented as it is, they have taken that challenge and decided to go deep on them several times. And now you imagine they're going to start getting the ball to Cam Robinson even more as this secondary backs up.
Look at the numbers for Clark to start this game. 5 of 6, 123, two touchdowns to Mikael Wood, and he's run for the other touchdown. Going to go to the air again. Whips it out there, sidearm, complete to Brendan Jenkins. First catch of the game for Brendan Jenkins, who's doesn't have the stats some of the other guys do, but such a big-time part of this team from a leadership standpoint. Son of former Atlanta Falcons wide receiver Michael Jenkins.
Illegal formation. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay, first down.
Yosarian Tomlinson, our referee, and the rest of the crew working this 7A semifinal tonight.
Brandon Jenkins, as you said, former teammate of mine, Michael Jenkins, comes from that pedigree. And when you look at his size, those guys, some guys just get into that next level. You're talking about 6'2", 6'3", 200 pounds, knows what he can do with the ball, doesn't get a lot of opportunity in this offense, but definitely has the talent.
Cam Robinson hitting the backfield, made a man miss. Nice gain to the 45-yard line. Cam Robinson. He was our Make That Kid an Offer nominee on Recruiting 2022 a couple of weeks ago.
All vision right there by Cam Robinson. He saw Moran coming out the corner of his eye, went immediately to a jump cut to bounce outside, and what a thrilling player. We called a game earlier this year, and the question was, could he handle playing inside the box? What a great job he's done.
Caleb Downs has a first down all the way down to the 43-yard line. 12-yard pickup, Caleb Downs.
The thing you love about Caleb Downs with the ball in his hands, as you see on the punt return, kickoffs returned, he never seems panicked.
No.
He just seems like he's out for a little stroll. How many of you want some of this? I mean, I'm the number one player in the state. He's just so impactful doing little plays like that. One of those seniors that really bought in and was engaged with their team this season.
Number one player in the state, and he certainly plays like it. Mill Creek playing like the number one team in the state right now. 21-0 lead on Milton after one quarter in this 7A semifinal at Lakewood.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Record-breaking winds and rainfall combined the area last night as an unexpected.
Hey, Danny. You want to make it through the storm last night? Don't worry, I'm on my way. Let's go to work, Lucky.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance.
A game without a crowd is just a scrimmage. A performance without an audience is just a rehearsal. Without your presence, high school sports and the performing arts aren't possible. Ensure that these essential extracurricular activities continue to enrich the lives of students in Georgia. Purchase a ticket to your local high school's game or performance.
This message presented by the GHSA.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Night has come in downtown Atlanta as we start the second quarter in Mill Creek on top of Milton. 21-0. Matt Stewart along with Wayne Gandy, John Nelson, Autumn Johnson, and Hannah Gooden. Thanks for joining us. This is a doubleheader. Twice as nice here on this Football Friday in Georgia. We've got Langston Hughes and Rome coming up in the 6A semifinals. And Hayden Clark, look at his numbers after one quarter. I don't know that he gets enough credit for what this Mill Creek offense has done this year.
He's been a tremendous leader and played within himself. Great game manager, just kind of takes what the defense gives him and knows how to use the weapons around him. And right now, he's in a groove, and you imagine they're going to continue to go to the well down the field.
High snap. He corrals it, keeps the play alive, and avoids a negative play right there.
Looks like maybe
I got hurt.
Hurt his arm right there, his left arm.
Wow, he's hanging his limp off. Yeah, I don't know what happened. His hand, I think it's his wrist or his hand.
As he tried to corral the snap, you saw Cam Robinson running to him.
He's going to have to come out of the game. What a terrible blow this would be for Mill Creek if Hayden Clark is injured.
Looks like he's getting a little better as he walks, but could have just got his arm jammed there as he snapped a little high. He tries to bring it down. And
maybe there?
Maybe on the stiff
right
arm.
There.
Right
That's
there.
That's probably where it had. Yeah, it's on the stiff arm.
He definitely got hit on the arm by Lawson. Maybe a stinger.
Yeah.
Just be a stinger.
That's what it seemed like. The reaction seemed to indicate something like a stinger. Shane Throgmorton, the sophomore quarterback, will check in. And they'll treat Hayden Clark on the bench.
You expect Clark out. They're going to get this run game going. This offensive line already counted on to do a great job.
Cam Robinson dashes in the hole down to the 38-yard line and still on his feet. Or did the ball come out? No, he just stayed on his feet. They never got him on the ground, and he ends up at the 34.
Big-time player showing you the whole package right here. Great vision. The burst of speed to get up into that hole, and then that non-quit attitude he seems to play with, as you could see, never on the ground, on top of a pile of bodies, scrambling and pick up that first down.
A little bit short of the first down, it appears. Second down and one.
Two tight formation in. Mullins, Nick Maxey in there as well.
Cam Robinson spins in the hole. Owen Phillips got his mitts on him, picks up a first down. And Wayne, you hit the nail on the head. If indeed Hayden Clark is injured, I think this dramatically changes your outlook for the rest of this game, because you want Hayden Clark to be healthy for a state final if you get to it. You might just, turn this into a running game, since you already got a three-touchdown lead, and just keep this thing on the ground. Let's play conservative. Nobody else get hurt, right?
Make them beat you. Don't turn the ball over. Get behind your pads.
First punt of the game by Kevin Mitchell. Looks like his body got out in front of his feet.
Very capable senior in Mitchell. More of the power back in this system. And when you look at it, they can roll in this situation with Robinson, Mitchell, Downs getting there and spell. But this offensive line up front, they're going to Bothwell, Banfield over there, left guard, 68. What a player he is, one of the top players on this team. Doesn't get a lot of credit, but just a freak athlete that has great size and can move his feet.
Second down. Going to pass it. Throgmorton to the air. Got a man open. Another Mill Creek touchdown. Mikael Wood with his third touchdown reception in the first 13 minutes of the game. This one goes for 33 yards.
Great scheme. Consistent in their mindset. If they see Mikael Wood matched up one-on-one on the outside, great protection. Look at this. Able to view the field, throw the ball out as Throgmorton. This time on DeBron Gatling and Mikael Wood for the touchdown.
Ulrich on for the PAT again. Four touchdown lead for the Mill Creek Hawks. Mikael Wood having a career night. Third touchdown reception for him, no matter who the quarterback is. 28-0, Mill Creek in command.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
At Lakewood, Mill Creek on top, 28-0. There's injured quarterback Hayden Clark. Let's get an update from Autumn Johnson.
Yeah, I'm on the sidelines near him right now, you guys, and he's been working with the athletic trainer right now. She's massaging his left leg with a massage gun. He's in really good spirits, though, been shaking it out, stretching his legs, getting some sprints in, but he's been dapping up his guys, all good in spirits and smiling, so he should be good to go, but no timetable on his turn just yet.
Thank you, Autumn, for that update. Could be that the hand's okay. They're just now just trying to make sure nothing's tightened up here as the weather's cooling down a little bit on this Friday night.
He's definitely moving that arm that we thought he hurt very well. But what an explosive play there by his backup, Shane Throgmorton, to the end zone, to the on fire Mikael Wood.
I think he hit the nail on the head. I think it was kind of a stinger when that's when he gave the stiff arm and his hand hit the helmet. And like I said, Ulrich is one of the top special teams weapons in the state. Certainly gotten my vote for kicker on the GPB All-State team. We'll see how the rest of the votes pan out here at Georgia Public Broadcasting, but he's the best I've seen this year. And we've seen a lot of good ones. It's a tough choice, but kickoffs, field goals, punting, he's a special kicker. Just a junior, has been offered by Stetson. You take a look at Milton and the total yards. They had 51 on a run by Moskowitz. They've had two total yards on the 10 plays since. Nickel stands in the pocket, trying to get to Esley at the 40.
Coming with the pressure once again. Linebackers up in the line. Devin Ankrum right there, able to get home, get a hit on Luke Nickel. And this young sophomore right now in this offense, offensive coordinator Stevie Jackson, they're going to just have to go out on the field, try to get a couple of first downs. It's early, but they got to go to that mindset that we're having, other than the run, we haven't gotten the ball. We haven't gotten the first down. We're not getting anything done offensively. Where can we go? Gatlin, Esley, where do we go to start getting some energy?
Heavy rush, Nickel in trouble, quarterback sack. Jamal Anderson tracks him down from behind for his fourth quarterback sack of the season.
A lot of pressure, no one really taking Jamal Anderson. You can see him coming off the edge, big time speed off the edge, long frame. And in that situation, if you Luke Nickel, you're not going to outrun an athlete like Anderson and get away. And you can see each and every play, this defense of Mill Creek, they're just getting more and more aggressive. They're stacking the line, challenging this offense.
Third and 19 after the sack by Anderson. Nickel, pocket breaking down. He goes down inside the 5-yard line. This time it's Cole Mullins, I believe, with the quarterback sack.
Cole Mullins doing a great job from that middle linebacker, just pushing the pocket. What a physical specimen he is. 6'5", 231, just driving the fullback back to the quarterback. Nice job, as you can see, just pushing the pocket, getting off the block, and making the sack.
Seventh quarterback sack of the season for Cole Mullen. Trouble, a short kick that bounces about 15 yards and rolls dead at the 47. The Mill Creek will be working with a short field and already leading 28-0. 48-yard kick, as it turns out. But Milton in a heap of trouble.
Coach Lovelady and this offense has just become a true weapon across the board, right?
235 total yards, and we've only played 16 minutes out of 48. So first and 10 from the 47.
Looks like we got Hayden Clark back in the game. Good to see that.
Low throw. It was a catch for Wood. Wood, prior to that catch, already at 145 yards receiving on the night and over 1,000 for the season.
When you start making these kind of catches, Matt, they call that just being in the zone. Right now, Mikael Wood is just in a zone, throwing the ball. Most likely he's going to come up with it. 50-50 balls, low throw. Nice job going down to the shoestrings and picking that up for his quarterback.
Second down and four. Cam Robinson, a couple of yards on the play.
Nice
out
hit.
To the 39.
Number 10 right there. Caleb Moran. What a big time player he is. Comes in this game with 9 sacks. Watch number 10 deliver punishment right there at the end. Big body at 215.
You see why Ben Reeves called him an absolute animal on defense.
Physicality in that play in every way.
That was a vicious hit. Got 4 offers, including Air Force and Army. Robinson, first down.
Cam Robinson, can't talk enough about a young man who moved to this position out of the slot. And you know the shiftiness, you know the speed, but the way he finishes runs for a former slot receiver right there, you just see he takes us on the challenge. He doesn't bounce plays to the outside. Looks like we have a player down.
Yeah, you don't typically think of slot receivers trucking people. I think that might be Caleb Moran, who just had that tackle 2 plays ago. Looks like he's shaken up on the play.
Already with that harness on that left arm. Maybe jammed it. Definitely can't afford to lose him when you're trying to come back in a game like this. Just been lights out for this defense.
Yeah. He missed early part of the season with injury. And it looked early on in the year like he was going to commit to Toledo. And then things didn't work out there. And a lot of teams backed off the recruiting because they thought he was going to commit to Toledo. So he's kind of in a situation as we approach National Signing Day, the first one, where his recruitment has kind of reopened. Good news is there's a second National Signing Day in February. So certainly hope things work out for Caleb Moran. He has, as you can tell, is a very physical linebacker. Kevin Mitchell, he gets about 3 down to the 26.
Looks like Shane Throckmorton is back in the game. Hayden Clark, we saw him take the first snap of this series. Not sure if that hamstring is just bothering him. And right now, if you coach Lovelady, you want to make sure of that, especially up 28-0. So you got a little cushion here to really find out what's going on.
Yeah. Hand off goes Cam Robinson, another couple of yards on the play. And you're up 28-0. You haven't won the game yet, but you're in a comfortable position. And you've already seen the reality of the situation. Hey, a star player can get hurt at any time. You don't play careful. When you play too careful, you end up getting hurt even worse. But I think there's something to getting conservative here, because the way things are going, looks like you're going to have one more game, and that would be the state championship game a week from tomorrow at Georgia State.
And Hayden Clark being on the sideline could just be a function of being 28-0, and you just feel comfortable, as you're saying. We're just going to buy a little time right here, see if we can get a bigger spread in the offense.
Throgmorton catch made at the 19-yard line by Jenkins.
Nice job of Jenkins coming back to the ball. Shane Throgmorton, good protection up front. Clean pocket. Knows where he wants to go with the ball. Nice job of Jenkins going back. And as we talked about with Jenkins, physically gifted, good size, big receiver, great at that 50-50 ball.
That was a spectacular short yardage catch. I mean, it really was. I mean, that was textbook. He does have 11 offers, including Mercer, Lehigh, and Middle Tennessee. Going to swing it out here, Caleb Downs. Watch him go. And that's going to be a touchdown for Caleb Downs.
Great job, Shane Throgmorton, stepping in. And at the moment, if you didn't look at the jersey number, you would think he's Hayden Clark, the way he's throwing this ball. Just a little swing pass to the best player in the state. Not the best player on the field, the best player on the state. Just a little swing route to the outside, get the ball into Caleb Downs' hands. And as I said earlier in the game, when he has the ball, it looks like he's on cruise control. So confident in his size and speed. Big time touchdown run for Mr. Caleb Downs.
Josh Lovelady called him a generational talent. You're getting a once in a generation chance to watch him.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Welcome back to Lakewood Stadium. You can't talk about Mill Creek without talking about Caleb Downs, the number one player in Georgia and number 11 in the nation. He just scored a touchdown, and he's been so incredible for this team all season long. His stats and highlights speak for itself, but he also has a very strong bloodline of athletes in his family. I asked head coach Lovelady, is there anything about him on the field that you see him do that simply can't be coached? He said there's many things that has him in awe. Caleb's ability to break on the ball before it's thrown, his timing, his physicality, IQ, preparation, and he can drop the hammer and be a linebacker in seconds. Athleticism is in his DNA, and it just comes natural to him.
Absolutely. His dad, Gary, former NFL running back, starred at NC State, now the running back coach at East Tennessee. His brother, Josh, junior all-ACC wide receiver at North Carolina. And perhaps you've heard of his uncle, Dre Bly. He's the secondary coach in North Carolina and a Pro Bowl player in the National Football League.
Dre Bly, one of the all-time Rams, won the Super Bowl back with them about 21, 22 years ago. But what a player. And it seems like maybe his dad, his cousin, his is all of them have taught him something because he can do it all out on the football field.
Yeah, he's a college football ready player now. You look at him, like Ben Reeves said, when we saw them in the playoffs last year, I was just in awe looking across the field at this NFL safety that they had. At the time, he was just a junior. It's going to be fun to watch him play college football. Looks like he's going to have one more game in his high school football career. Luke Nickel going to run for the first down. Just the second first down that they have had in this game. 13-yard pickup.
Nice job. Nickel, nothing down the field. Defensive front getting out of his lane right there. If you're Caleb Etchison, you got to be able to stay in your lane. Jamal Anderson is to your outside. Nice find there by Nickel. Just try to get something here before half with this offense.
You might remember the name Nickel. His brother Jack was a four-year starter, was a freshman on their 2018 state championship team, and now a freshman tight end at Michigan State. Running a reverse here. And that's Bryce Thornton. Second time we've seen Thornton touch the ball. Bryce has committed to Florida. He did that back in October, a four-star safety. His brother Bruce, freshman point guard for the Ohio State Buckeyes.
So much pressure off the edge there by Cole Mullins. He was so up the field that when Bryce Thornton got this ball to come back around, he had to belly back another 4 or 5 yards. And with the speed of this defense, you got to go straight at it. You're not going to really trick this kind of defense. And you talk about the Hawks.
Bryce Thornton's been bothered by nagging injuries this season. Coach Ben Reeves actually approached him and said, look, if you want to shut it down, get ready for your college football career, I wouldn't blame you. Bryce says, look, I want to finish this football team with my brothers. I want to finish out this season playing high school football. I'm a Milton Eagle right now, not a Florida Gator. And looks like their season might come to an end here tonight. They're down big in the second quarter, but I love to hear those stories. Caleb Downs is another one like it. Guys that don't check out early, they finish out their high school football careers strong.
Stay in the moment, enjoy the moment. The next moment will definitely take care of itself. And you're right, it's just great to see guys with all this fame and publicity still be engaged in trying to accomplish the big goal of a state championship.
Third down and four, Nickel. First down catch by Gatling. Gatling moves the sticks for the Eagles. Second catch for Gatling.
Very little pressure in the face of Luke Nickel for the first time tonight, able to find Gatling in front of Trajan Greco. And as we talked about, Gatling, one of those guys having a superhero type season. As you can see, clean pocket to throw to Trajan Greco. He knows I got to hurry up and get the talent of Gatling down. I can't just let him run the ball, reset his hips. Got to get him down quick.
2 years ago, before Gatling had ever played a varsity game, his coach at the time, Adam Clack, told me that this guy was going to be one of the most spectacular wide receivers that he'd ever coached. And he certainly has lived up to that as Nickel runs for the first down, or close to it. And he's been tutored this year by their wide receiver coach, Terrence Edwards, the former great Georgia Bulldog, Washington County star, who last month was inducted into the Georgia High School Football Hall of Fame.
Feeling the pressure coming from his left, quarterback draw all the way to get him from that edge pressure. Luke Nickel having to make a couple of plays with his feet in this game, but whatever it takes to try to give your team a chance, he has to do right now.
Yeah, Nickel's a tough dude, just like his brother Jack. He'll stick his helmet in there. He's not one that wants to slide. That's a completion to Esley at the 30-yard line.
Up 35-0, this Hawk defense on this series of downs.
Milton
is playing a little soft. He's going to keep things in front of him, make you beat them and come back in this game.
So, yeah, take what they give you. Right now, they're giving you some space to operate, try to get some points here before halftime. Buckle up, Georgia. Buckle up, Georgia. Seatbelt save lives. Let's check in with Hannah Gooden. Find out what's coming up at halftime.
Thanks, Matt. Big night around the state. It's GHSA semifinal time. 32 teams in action. We're narrowing that down to 16. And John and I are going to break it all down for you on Bracketology. Who could be punching their tickets to the GHSA championships next week at Center Park Stadium? We're the only team kicked off. We have a lot more games coming up, and it's all coming up at halftime in just a few minutes, guys.
Looking forward to that, Hannah. That's right. We've got another semifinal right here on GPB. Following this one, we'll also have a special edition of Recruiting 2022 in between our semifinals. We'll get you caught up on all the college football news of the week. We've had a lot of decommitments. This is not unusual. You get late in the process, late November, early December, guys start having second thoughts, decommitting, reevaluating where they're going. Darren Reed, the fine defensive lineman from Carver Columbus, flipped from LSU to Auburn this week. So good news for your Auburn Tigers, Wayne Gandy.
The Travis Hunter effect. Yeah. I think they're going to start calling that, where guys just at that last moment decide, I'm going to go somewhere else where they might feel has a better opportunity.
Second down and three here from Milton, coming out of the timeout. Nickel wants to run it again. Dives forward. I believe he has the first down at the 26.
And those are the plays right now they're going to give Luke Nickel. You see the secondary, they kind of backed off. They're going to let you see if you can put a drive together. You really haven't threatened us on the back end. So if you're going to take those 4 or 5 yard runs, we're going to let you have it and see if you can beat the clock before halftime.
First and 10. Then a runner reverse to Gatling. Gatling going to throw it downfield. Had Nickel there, but Caleb Downs was there too. So perhaps good that the ball was not on the money.
And Nickel seemed like he gave up on this route. You could see as Gatling came around, he was looking more for the end zone. He was looking for number 5 down the way. A little double reverse, trying to get the ball on a pass to the quarterback. Nice execution, trying to just drift down the field. And you're right, Caleb Downs, he wasn't fooled at
no,
all.
No, he wasn't.
He stayed back in the defense. He never got drawn up. Nice job.
Second down and 10. Ninth play of the drive right here. Nickel going for the end zone. Got his man, and it's brought in for a touchdown by Bryce Thornton.
Nice find there by Luke Nickel. Get some positive energy going in at half. Bryce Thornton having to play Superman tonight. We've seen him a couple of times trying to get the ball in his hand. Actually, on this play, got lost. Jaden Patterson, the free safety, just losing sight of Bryce Thornton on that touchdown reception.
So Milton finally on the board as Moda puts it through the PAT, and it's 35-7.
Starts with the protection. Great job. Able to step into the throw. Having to double catch the ball there is Thornton, but good concentration. And as you can see, kind of just out there by himself. No one's in coverage. You saw Jaden Patterson, 13, running to the ball, patting his chest. My bad. I busted coverage there.
Here's a look at the Milton resume. 2018 state champions last year, 2021 state finalists, got beat by Collins Hill in the last game. They've won 5 straight region titles. The last 5 seasons, they've gone 55-15. And for those who are not longtime viewers of high school football in Georgia, I kind of compare the Milton football story to the Atlanta Braves. There was a time when the Atlanta Braves were the worst team in baseball. There's a lot of people that don't remember that because they've been good for so long. There was a time when Milton, quite frankly, was one of the worst football programs in the state. But there's a lot of people that don't remember that because Milton has been so good now for close to a decade. Onside kick, and it's recovered. Could be a take back right here. and a touchdown for Mill Creek. They were waiting on it. Wow. What a turn of events right there. Miles Gindelsberger, a sophomore defensive lineman, finds himself in the spotlight with a 47-yard scoop on the onside attempt and takes it back for the touchdown.
Nice job of Miles G of not turning his hips on this play. You could see he was keeping his eye on the ball, not sure whether he was reading a key or not, but he really hadn't opened his hips up to go back on the return team. Nice job of him not only getting the ball, but having the wherewithal to get the ball and run it back for a touchdown.
Yeah, he had no second thoughts, man. He took that thing on the hop and went the other way with it. 47-yard kick return touchdown for Miles Gindelsberger.
Unsportsmanlike. Offense. The touchdown is good. The penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
So you're saying they celebrated? Yeah, I don't fault him on that one.
It's always interesting to everybody can celebrate except the person that scores the touchdown.
Ulrich puts it through 42-7. So Milton scores and Mill Creek gets it right back. Watch this play by Miles Gindelsberger.
Nice job, as I said. Never turned his hip. Ran right into the ball right there. Good job of him keeping his wits about him. And we've seen so far in a game like this, you felt like Milton was going to have to try a couple of gambles. No real indication they were going to do it right there, but nice job of Mill Creek and their special teams.
How about a moment in the sun for Miles Gindelsberger, 6'2", 180 sophomore. Probably never thought that he'd score a touchdown tonight, but he does right there. Yeah, good-looking ball player, too. Got some size on him and got some speed on him, too, as Mill Creek has now gone over 40 points for the 11th time this season in 14 games.
And that's what made this team so good this year. When we've seen them, they win as a team. They have all three phases, offense, special teams, defense. And I just love, I like to bump it into him in like 20 years. You know that will be a 68-yard touchdown. It'll grow in yardage as the years go by.
Problem with that is it's on video. It can be fact-checked. 47 yards is good enough. Bouncing kick covered by Milton at the 45 and about a 3-yard return. So interesting response there by Mill Creek to do the bouncing kick. I don't know why you give Milton a short field there when you got Ulrich who can blast it through the back of the end zone.
Definitely an interesting decision. It wasn't an onside. Really wasn't even a pooch kick. It's not sure if it just went off his foot bad. Great field position here for Milton to try a couple of shots down the field. And I think you can see Coach Love.
He might be like, what happened
looking
there?
Him up like, who called that?
Who said do that? Because yeah, that doesn't really kind of fit with what's going on here. So Milton, well, get a shot to maybe get some more points here before halftime as they are 54 yards away from the end zone.
Empty backfield here for Nickel.
Nickel going for the home run. His receiver broke off the route because the pass was way out of bounds. How about a one-handed catch by Cam Robinson on the sideline?
Great coverage there by Caleb Buckman. Good job by him. Cam Robinson. With the score being the way it is, you imagine second half early on, he gets some carries, yeah. But he's one of those guys, as we talked about with his quarterback, with this kind of score, they might phase him out real quick.
Yeah, I mean, you got another game to go. You do have a little bit longer week because the state championship for 7A will be the last of the eight. That'll be the 7 o'clock kickoff on December 10th at Center Park Stadium.
Milton.
So Milton uses the timeout, and that will leave them with two. So if you're Ben Reeves, what's the message in the locker room, Wayne?
It's going to be a tough conversation with your team about commitment and hard work and one play at a time. I mean, it's going to be one of those old start at the basics, and it has to be something that they have to start early and stay committed.
Here's a look at the top prospects for the Mill Creek Hawks. Caleb Downs, you know, committed to Alabama. You've seen Jamal Anderson get a quarterback sack tonight. He's committed to Clemson. And by the way, Clemson has really loaded up in the state of Georgia for 2023. We'll have more on that in our recruiting 2022 segment between the games. Mikael Wood committed to Eastern Michigan, already had a spectacular game. Aiden Banfield, I know he's a guy that you've had your eye on. He's a three-star junior, has offers including Georgia Tech and Vanderbilt, and Cole Mullins, we've talked about him as well.
Banfield, definitely one of those guys that right now he's been playing more guard, but with his height and his footwork, can definitely slide out to play left tackle, which is always great for an O-lineman.
So second down and 10 coming out of the Mill Creek timeout. Heavy rush, nickel being chased, gonna run to the sideline, get tripped up, going out of bounds at the 49-yard line. That was Anglin making the tackle.
Anglin getting him a couple of push-ups there at the end. That's the kind of player he is. It's just sideline to sideline, one of those guys that if he can grab another inch or two at that middle linebacker position, number 26 here, always working towards the ball, going to come out of your screen, hustle, and get you a little set of push-ups right there just to keep everything tight. It's Mr. Anglin, but what a season he's put together as well.
Team leading 80 tackles at the start of the night, 13 TFL, 4 quarterback sacks. 3rd and 8, nickel being chased, being harassed. Gonna throw on the run, misses guy. That's a tough throw. Trying to get the guy, Robert Billings. So their two best offensive players in this half have been, well, Bryce Thornton, who has their one touchdown, and then Rob Billings, who's his partner at safety and also committed to Clemson.
And the score has really taken away one of their big weapons that has gotten them this far, Moskowitz. Yeah. He's not been able to do much. His style is more tight games to end the game, but when you're down 35, it phases him out of the rotation.
So the short kick doesn't hurt Mill Creek. There's Robert Billings headed to Clemson. Trouble the punt. Gonna bounce out of bounds. We'll see where they spot it with 12 seconds to go in the half. The 21 is where they will spot it. A 32-yard kick by Trouble.
Shane Throckmorton has done excellent in short work, has really cemented this game in a lot of ways. His ability to come in and keep the same offense going.
Yeah.
They did not pull back on the offense because he was inserted.
They've gone into their victory formation here for the end of the half. Take a knee, that'll be the final play, and what a first half for Mill Creek as they are now just 24 minutes away from their first ever state championship game. And it would take a monumental comeback by Milton to deny them that.
Truly was all about early on Mikael Wood. It became the Mikael Wood show with 3 early big touchdowns down the field.
Let's send it to Autumn Johnson, who's standing by with head coach Josh Lovelady.
Coach, coach. I mean, your offense lights out, and then on defense, suffocating. What impressed you most about your team's first half performance?
Just the speed of play, you know, getting after it, lining up correct, and getting after it as far as the physicalness of the game.
What about the status of your quarterback, Hayden Clark? What can you tell us about him?
I'll give you the halftime. We'll see what the doctors say and see what's going on. Obviously, he had some big runs in there and some great balls. So we're going to go check it out with the doctors and see what they say.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Hannah, back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Adam. Great job. Coming up on the Region's Halftime Show, we'll hear from Rome senior defensive lineman Stephylin Green. That game is next at 8. Update you on which teams are punching their tickets to the GHSA Championship. Take a look at our play of the first half. Preview some flag football semis. It's all right here next on GPB.
Jackson EMC and 31 other participating Georgia Electric membership cooperatives congratulate Mill Creek High School on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events.
We feel like this is this kind of shows the character of our kids and shows really what our coaches try to instill in them and our teachers as well as far as how to handle themselves both in wins and losses. And we're proud that this was something that was recognized by our peers throughout the county and the state.
So it just shows how much respect we have to put on the field, like showing good sportsmanship and like just looking out for the younger kids, because one day the younger kids are going to be in our spots and we want them to put on a great brand for ourselves.
Introduced in 2006, this award reinforces the GHSA's philosophy that everyone associated with high school activities, from athletes to spectators, should adhere to the fundamental values it represents.
Jackson EMC is proud to present the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award at Mill Creek High School in Gwinnett County. At Jackson EMC, we live in the communities we serve. So as a Mill Creek parent, I firsthand see why Mill Creek deserves this award. Our student athletes, coaches, fans, and teachers exhibit the values of accountability, integrity, and respect every day.
Georgia's EMCs and the 32 participating membership cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to the Mill Creek Hawks community.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your breath, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
When you think football, how can you not think about food?
Tailgate snacks, watch party apps, football food is the best, which is why we're kicking off something tasty this year.
Touchdown Tizers is all about sharing those all-time favorite recipes, talking about our most loved dishes, and celebrating the traditions that bring us all together.
Visit gpb.org/touchdown to find your new favorite recipe.
Fridays in Georgia Halftime Show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the 7A semifinal game between Mill Creek and Milton at Lakewood Stadium. We've got a doubleheader on deck for you tonight. This game will be followed by the 6A matchup between Rome and Langston Hughes at 8 o'clock p.m. Both of those teams are loaded with talent, including Rome's senior defensive lineman, Stephylin Green. He's committed to Clemson, but has some unfinished business to do with the Wolves. Here's his thoughts on tonight's game against the Panthers.
I feel like their offense is pretty good. That's why they've been winning games. But I feel like
I feel like our defense and our confidence in each other, we're gonna be good. I feel like our defense can hold up and stop the run and pass and get pressures on the QB to stop them and win that game.
Looking forward to that one, but he's not all brawn. He's also brains. One of the reasons he chose the Tigers is because of academics. He wants to study mechanical engineering. Watch the full interview and learn more about Green's recruiting process on this week's episode of Recruiting 2022. It will air in between games. All right, guys, stick with us. We'll check in with John for Bracketology next on GPB.
The day has finally come for our rollover crash. And to emphasize just how important this research is for Georgia drivers, we're joined by GHSA's director, Chris Wigington.
The Accident Reconstruction Lab is important to us in the state of Georgia and across the nation. This research that we do here, we're able to create these accident scenes and then work the formulas backwards to validate the testing. And so we can use that to reduce accidents by educating the public and hopefully prevent maybe them from being involved in a rollover collision.
And the best way to drive this point home is to roll this car over.
So today we redid the crash with the rollover, and I will call it a success. What happened here is what we see a lot of times with crashes, inexperienced drivers particularly, will drift off the road and they'll panic and they'll dynamically put steering in to try to come back up on the road. And it basically, the center mass outruns the tires and then it rolls over. I think it rolled over 3 times. And we had a full ejection from one of the mannequins in the car, and we had a partial ejection on the second one. So seatbelts save lives. I think we just demonstrated that with this wreck. If you're going to be in a car and you lose control and the car rolls over or strikes an object, your seatbelts can buy you valuable time and keep you locked in the seat. Failure to wear a seatbelt can have catastrophic effects.
And though the crash research is complete, don't forget to check out the Rollover Crash VR Perspective launching next week during the GHSA Football Championships.
Hi, I'm Tommy Sharp with You Save It Pharmacy, and I'm proud to present to you this week's You Save It Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week.
I remember first starting out when they told me we're changing you to linebacker. I kind of laughed at it.
And there was a transition phase. He'd never played it before. Here had a tremendous junior year, and that's where you're seeing he had 50, 60 offers.
Definitely just being around my dad, I've always envisioned myself being better than him.
I hope you've enjoyed watching You Save It's Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week. If you'd like to watch our full interview, please follow this link.
Welcome back. It's the GHSA semifinals around the state where 32 teams are playing. We'll be narrowing it down to the final 16. Let's take a look at what's to come on Georgia's EMC scoreboard. Georgia's EMC is so much more than electricity. We're in halftime of the 7A matchup between Mill Creek and Milton. The Hawks are up big 42-7. The winner of our game will face Carrollton or Colquitt County. That game begins at 7:30. Then in 6A, we'll be broadcasting Rome versus Langston Hughes next right here on GBB. Kickoff is set for 8 o'clock at Lakewood Stadium. And the winner of that game will face either Gainesville or Roswell. That one starts at 8 o'clock as well. Time to bring in my buddy John Nelson for some bracketology. And John, since we've already told you what's going on in 7A and 6A, you wanted to talk 3A because that bracket is extremely intriguing.
Yeah, and you know, here in public broadcasting, there's a particular show that airs here. And one of the routines is one of these things is not like the other. So let's go ahead and show you AAA in that particular bracket. One of these things is not like the other. It's Oconee County, because Carver Atlanta, Sandy Creek, and Cedar Grove are all from the same region. Three of the four teams made it out of Region 5, and they are three of the final four. Carver Atlanta and Sandy Creek on the left-hand side. is a rematch of a 22-12 win by Sandy Creek during the regular season. So tonight, can Darren Miles and Carver Atlanta get revenge on the rematch? We'll look at that on the left-hand side. Oconee County has done really well this year, coming through as a 3 seed, knocking off Lumpkin County as a 2, Adairsville as the 1 seed low right, and then beating Carver Columbus last week. So 3A, 3 teams, 1 region, you go to AA. Show you what's going on here. And this one, and so you look at AAA, Hannah, so that one was fun. So you look at AA, and I've always maintained that AA is one of the toughest regions on the board across, you know, with all of the teams that could have made a run. You could sit there and go 2 or 3 rounds deep and go, I can see a reason why this team would make it into the Final Four. Fitzgerald and Fellowship Christian, that one's at JC Stadium at 7:30 on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, Appling County and Thompson, caught up with both of those coaches earlier this week from my column at gpb.org/sports, subtle plug. And we caught up with Coach Mullis to find out what it is about Appling County and their run. Thompson, great run by the Bulldogs, and head coach Michael Youngblood. By the way, piece of trivia involving the head coach for Thompson. He was in one of the first championship games that we ever aired here on Georgia Public Broadcasting when Burke County made it to the last game of the year. Michael Youngblood was a part of that game in his time at Burke County. The Burke County Bears, Waynesboro, Georgia, the bird dog capital of the world, has produced the Thompson head coach, and they're in one of the tightest games tonight in AA. AA, one of the toughest classifications, Hannah, across the board.
Another storyline we're following, John, there's 3 teams that are making semifinal appearances for the first time. That is St. Francis, Dutchtown in 5A, Schley County in single A Division 2. What are your expectations out of those teams?
Well, St. Francis, they've got a tall order tonight on the right-hand side of the bracket. Great run by Frank Barden as they've made it all the way through. They've got a tough order going up against Prince Avenue Christian. You see Schley County and Johnson County also in single A. That's going to be one of the toughest games on the board. And then on the left-hand side of the bracket, as you're filling things out in 5A, Ware County and Dutchtown, a tall order for Nikita Battle and the Bulldogs going up against Ware County down there in Waycross tonight. Kickoff a little after 7:30. So tough runs for a couple of them, having to do this on the road if they're going to make it to the last game of the year.
We got a little more time, John, so I want to ask you, what are your thoughts so far on our game right now, Mill Creek versus Milton? This has been all Hawks.
It has been dominant. 3 syllables worth of dominance from what we've seen from Mill Creek so far. But as we've said, and what Matt and Wayne have said so far, this game leading into this one, offense has been dynamic for Mill Creek all season long. Tonight has been absolutely no different when it comes to what we've seen from Mill Creek. They just put the pedal down early, and the personification, I think, of the first half was picking up the onside kick and running it all the way back for the score to keep the margin at 35. They're at 42-7 here at the break. Just dominance on offense, defense, and special teams here in the first 24 minutes.
Thanks, John. We'll be checking in with you throughout the game for all the latest updates around the state as those games get kicked off. We're not done with halftime just yet. We'll show you our play of the first half and update you on flag football next. Alcohol abuse claims the lives of too many of our friends and family here in Georgia. Kirk Erickson, Cigna General Manager for Georgia and Alabama, is here with tips on how to get help for yourself and your loved ones. Kirk, why is it so important to talk about alcohol abuse here in Georgia?
Well, alcohol is the primary drug of choice for more than half of Georgians who seek treatment for abuse. So it's drunk driving impacts more than 1 in 5 of traffic fatalities. And it is absolutely an issue that impacts all of us. It impacts our communities, it impacts our families, it impacts our job sites.
Should we be concerned about teenagers and alcohol?
Most certainly. Most recent statistics show that 25% of Georgia teens have had at least 1 drink in the past month. 10% of Georgia teens are currently binge drinking. And I think it's safe to say that 100% of Georgia teens experience peer pressure regarding drinking. We need to talk to them, because if we aren't, somebody else is. We need to model good behavior, because if we don't, no one else will.
Wow, those statistics are alarming. How do I get help for myself or a loved one?
Well, many employer health plans offer an EAP or employee assistance program, and many plans also offer substance abuse programs. It is not a problem to ask for help. That's not a sign of weakness, that's a sign of strength. Use those benefits that you have available to you. There are also free alternatives like Alcoholics Anonymous and Alateen. Ask for help if you need it.
What are the warning signs?
Boy, if you see your children or your loved ones drawing back socially, if you see your children having decreased grades or just behaving differently and maybe having fits of rage or things like that, our teens aren't very good at displaying moderation. And so they're prone to take things to excess. Just be looking for those types of behavioral changes. There's no one surefire sign, but all of those piled together can really give you a good indicator.
Kirk, this is so important, especially for our youth. So thank you for being here. And if you want to learn more about alcohol abuse in Georgia, please go to Cigna.com.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's faking your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and makes moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
And welcome back to the region's halftime show. If you're just now joining us, Hawks on top 42-7. Let's get right to our GPB play of the first half. A little over a minute into the game, first and 10 on the 46 for Mill Creek. Quarterback Hayden Clark airs it out to Mikhail Wood. He's got room. Touchdown, Hawks. That was 54 yards for the first score of the game. What a throw by Clark. His 23rd touchdown pass of the season. That right there set the tone for the entire first half. I've also got a girls flag football update for you. Last night was the quarterfinals, and we streamed the North Gwinnett versus Marietta game. The Blue Devils pulled it out 13-0 over the Bulldogs to punch their ticket to the semifinals, which will be held Monday, December 5th at the Falcons training facility in Flowery Branch. We'll be covering all the action, and you can watch the games live at gpb.org/sports. or the GPB Sports app. We're also streaming on social media. So all of the GHSA state championships will kick off next Thursday, December 8th, starting with girls flag football and boys single A Division 1 and 2 at 5 o'clock, then 8 o'clock. Then the evens will play on Saturday with double A starting things off at noon, followed by 4A at 3:30 and 6A at 7. Then the odds turn on Saturday. 3A plays at noon. Yes, and then that will be followed by 5A and 7A, finally rounding things out at 7. But we have to get through the semifinals first. That's it for halftime of Mill Creek versus Milton. We've got so much more. Don't forget doubleheader. It's Rome versus Hughes right after this. But more from Matt, Wayne, Autumn, John, and myself after this break.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
And welcome back in our GPB studios. Matt Stewart along with Wayne Gandy. What a first half for Mill Creek, and a 42-7 lead just two quarters away from going to the state finals for the first time ever. Before we talk about that, let's send it to Autumn Johnson. She's standing by with head coach Ben Reeves.
Coach, 42-7. When you were in the halftime right now in that locker room with these guys, what was your message?
Yeah, definitely not the way we drew it up, for sure. But, you know, at the beginning of the year, we decided our motto was going to be FIWB. Flush it, we ball. And that doesn't mean just in the good times. That means in the bad times, too. And that's how we're going to finish this game. We're going to flush it. We're going to go out and ball and see what happens. I don't know what's going to happen, but we're going to finish it the right way, emptying our tank, doing everything that got us here. And that's all we know how to do.
Which guy in the locker room really rallied this group together as a leader?
The seniors as a whole, you know. They've done so much for this program. They want to make sure that they go out the right way, and they want to make sure the underclassmen know that they're not going to quit. They don't care what the score is. We're going to go out and play football and see what happens and enjoy playing high school football, which could be the last time for a lot of them. And that was just the message of let's go play some ball. Follow me. Get my back. I got your back. I don't care what the score is. And just have fun as a team one more time.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Back to you, Matt.
Thank you, Autumn. Solid message right there from Ben Reeves for his team going into the third and fourth quarter.
You got to try to galvanize and start somewhere, and it starts with the team attitude coming out. Just play hard and let it fall where it falls.
It's high school football. Have fun. Let's take a look at the first half highlights. And, wow, Mill Creek had a lot of fun in the first half. Got started quickly with the 54-yard touchdown pass from Wood to Clark, or Clark to Wood.
Became a common theme early on. Clark once again down the field to Makai Woods for the second touchdown of the game.
That was a 19-yard pass play, and then Clark takes it in from 10 yards out. It was 21-0 in the first quarter.
And then Clark went to the sideline. Shane Throgmorton comes in, finds the hot hand once again of Makai Wood into the end zone.
Three touchdown receptions for Mikel Wood in that first half, and then this one goes to Caleb Downs. 19 yards for Downs on the play. Milton finally broke the ice in the final minute of halftime. Nickel going to Thornton. And then the onside kick by Milton after that touchdown turns into a take back the other way right here by Gendelsberger. 47 yards, a real shock factor there for Mill Creek to remind them, hey, you're not getting back in the game. 42-7 as we take a look at the halftime stats.
Total dominance by Mill Creek, especially with the big play down the field. Pretty clean game when you look as far as penalties and turnovers. But look at that third down conversion for Milton. Only 1 of 6. They had four, three and outs. Just a complete dominance on both of the sides of the ball by the Hawks.
So 42-7 as we get ready for the start of the second half. And I mean, certainly the task in front of Milton is formidable. You basically have to have everything go your way, plus some. Just not a normal game. I mean, this has to be something extraordinary. You've got to get some turnovers. You got to score on every possession. You got to get some special teams plays. And if you're Mill Creek, really kind of one of the things you have to do is just make sure you don't put yourself in position to make big mistakes.
Yeah, if you're Milton, your first goal is to try to keep this game from having a running clock in the fourth quarter. And on the flip side, with Mill Creek, just keep getting back to what you were doing and force that same situation. When you have that kind of big score, just try to keep a good long drive together with Cam Robinson.
Well, certainly a big night in the making for Josh Lovelady. At the end of these 24 minutes, he could be in the state finals for the first time ever. Third quarter kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seatbelt save lives as the kick from Ulrich goes into the end zone. And so Milton will start the third quarter from their 20-yard line. Luke Nickel, 4 of 12 passing for 53 yards. The one touchdown to Bryce Thornton. Rushing-wise, Moskowitz had a big 51-yard run on his first carry, and then only 5 yards the rest of the half. And Gatling, their top receiver, 2 catches for 20 yards. So here we go, start of the second half. Nickel looking and firing, and Esley Did he haul it in with the one hand? He did. Nice catch by Esley at the 36-yard line.
As we talked about, Esley has had a great season, becoming the second option behind Gatling. Good play fake here. Nice find by Nickel. Bringing it in with the one hand is Mark Esley.
So first and 10 from the 36.
Moskowitz back in the game. Try to keep the defense balanced. Run the ball a couple of times.
Heavy rush. Nickel gets it out of there. Trying to go to Moskowitz on the sideline. It'll be second down and 10.
Good coverage there by A.G. Langston. A.G. Haven't called his name tonight, but he has had a great job rounding out this linebacking core. Just a wheel route trying to get the ball out quickly. To Moskowitz, a lot of pressure. As you can see, Mill Creek has decided to start the half. They're going to bring pressure off the edge.
Second down and 10 from the 36. Nickel scrambling, going to take a sack back at the 30-yard line. Third quarterback sack of the night for the Hawks. This is going to be a combo job between Langston Agee and Bryce Bothwell.
Nice job of Agee, kind of spying on this play. When you watch him there, keeping his eye on Nickel, he sees he's not going to throw the ball, comes up, makes the tackle, and nice hustle there by Bothwell to get off the block and get into the play.
Bothwell, twin brother of offensive lineman, starting offensive lineman Cooper Bothwell, both of them have offers from Stetson and Marist. He's had a big night, a blocked field goal, and now a quarterback sack. Heavy rush from Jamal Anderson and Nickel. I thought his knee hit the ground. Apparently it did not. And finally, the pile is going to be blown dead at the 28-yard line.
And Jamal Anderson is one of those guys, his impact defensively sometimes gets lost because you're looking for the numbers. But he's asked, really, when you think about it, more of probably an outside DN player, but he stands up a lot. He's asked to drop back in coverage. This time just coming with the pressure right up in the face, pushing pushing Nickel back into the pocket, and then all the white jerseys right there rallying to the ball.
Trouble punts, fielded by Caleb Downs at the 36. And down to the 42. So my question to you as we start, Caleb Downs returning the punt. We'll see who comes out there at quarterback. How long do you keep your starters in this game?
Well, you got to keep them in that same mindset that they need to close this game out. So I expect these starters at least until they either tack on another touchdown or maybe put a long drive together and maybe the fourth quarter take them out. But you don't have to do it at once. You could just kind of sneak one or two guys out at a time, as we talked about, maybe starting with Cam Robinson, let him get a couple of carries and then pull him out of the game, put Kevin Mitchell in.
So Throgmorton back in there, quarterback, big run by Cam Robinson with a cut in the middle of the field. And Robinson all the way down to the 24-yard line before being caught by Bryce Thornton.
One of those runs where you're looking at the scoreboard like, hey, coach is going to take me out in a couple of snaps. Good blocking in the middle, just a draw play here. And this is what we know he can do out in the middle of the field, just that shiftiness, that speed. Big time play right there by Cam Robinson.
He has been so much fun to watch this season. First and 10, that was a 35-yard pickup. Throgmorton going to the end zone and overthrew Caleb Downs. He's been covered by Thornton.
Billings and Thornton on that back end. A lot of jerseys are always going to follow that man right there. You're going to keep two or three sets of eyes on him regardless of whether he gets the ball or not.
It's a future SEC matchup right there. Caleb Downs committed to Alabama and Bryce Thornton committed to Florida. Hayden Clark over on the sideline, he might stay there the rest of the game. Robinson close to a first down.
Nice job there. Aiden Banfield down the field, 68, finishing off the block there on Bryce Thornton. This offensive line doesn't get a lot of credit, but they have done a great job tonight. I don't know that we've seen either quarterback harassed. It really in any situation, good protection, and that was one of the keys to their win tonight, being able to control the line of scrimmage.
Third down and two. And Throg Martin fires, nearly intercepted inside the five-yard line by Thornton, threw behind his target right there, and it's fourth down and two.
Thornton definitely had a step right there on, Woods definitely had a step right there on Thornton. Just a little behind him, late on this quick slant here, trying to carry out the fake. You could see right there, lead Woods a little bit, touchdown. Missed right there by Mill Creek.
They're going to bring Ulrich on for the field goal attempt. He's 11 for 18 on the season. Kicked a 56-yarder in the Corky Kell Classic at MBS. This is a 32-yard kick. It's right through the uprights. The best I've seen in the state this year. 12th field goal of the season for Ulrich, and Mill Creek increases their lead to 38.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Record-breaking winds and rainfall combined
in
the area last night as an unexpected...
Hey, Danny. Y'all make it through the storm last night?
Don't worry. I'm on my way. Let's go to work, Lucky.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance.
We are a farm bureau.
Are you an enthusiastic sports fan? Want to have fun and get in on the action?
Heck yes, that'd be awesome.
Have great attention to detail? Want to stay active?
Definitely.
Want to give back to the student athletes in your community?
Obviously, yes.
Then you'd make an excellent high school sports official. We need more officials in Georgia, because with no high school officials, there are no high school sports. Sign up today at highschoolofficials.com.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Celebrating here, Mill Creek. 45-7 lead on Milton. Pretty live stadium here at Lakewood. We got another 6A semifinal coming up. After this one is Langston Hughes takes on Rome. Should be a fun game. And, you know, kicking is always important. We joke about kickers a lot, but kicking is so important. But especially in high school football, where if you kick the ball into the end zone, there's no return. Ulrich, 5 for 7 on touchbacks. Throw in the 32-yard field goal, too. That's nice. But no returns practically for Milton tonight in the kick game. You can, if you've got a great kicker in high school football, you can make the other 21 men on the field irrelevant. This kick from Ulrich is going to be taken. Nope, it's going to be out a touchback. It's right there just inside the goal line. So that's another one. 6 touchbacks for Ulrich tonight.
And I think Coach Lovelady must have found him on that sideline after that little screamer he sent right before the half. Like, hey, just kick it off, but you're right. You can find you a kicker that can consistently hit you a 40, 45-yarder in high school so that when your offense gets down there to that 20, you have that option, that 25. It's a great weapon. And Ulrich, with his range of 50, just makes this team even more dangerous.
Look at that. 14 yards since the 51-yard run by Moskowitz on their first rushing play of the game. Nickel. Gatling makes the catch at the 25. 5-yard pickup. Gatling. Third catch of the game for him.
Nice break on that tackle by Trajan Greco. We've seen that sense of urgency. One of those mindsets that DeBron Gatling, he's going to get a couple of balls. The key to having an effect on him is to stay in that tight coverage. And when he makes those catches, come up and make the tackle and not let him get those big plays.
Second down and five from the 25. That's G, the tight end, in motion. Pass got separated. That was Greco coming up and making another fabulous play. There's a flag out. That's his third PBU of the game.
Trajan Greco, we spoke all so highly of him, and deservingly so.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
So that's going to bail him out. What is it about those defensive linemen? You get a big lead, and they start wanting to tee off on the quarterback, don't they?
When they run all and put all that energy, they want to hit somebody. And right there, yeah, I think you got Nick Maxey, number 88 there. He's done all that work trying to get there from the edge, and sometimes they just forget their place. You can't have those kind of plays, even in a blowout.
Gatling saw the traffic headed his way. Langston Agee was getting ready to drop him, and he dropped the pass.
Agee, one of those hybrid safety linebacker types. And those tweeners, nice job of him right there breaking that pass up.
Langston Agee, the senior linebacker, 50 tackles on the season, two TFL, two quarterback sacks. Has three tackles in this game, one of them for loss, half quarterback sack. Pass goes to Billings, going to be short of the first down as he runs out of bounds at the 46.
Nice throw and catch between Nickel and Billings on this play. Long route. You have a flag on it as well. Only two penalties in that first half between both teams.
And Milton's not had a penalty called on them yet.
They're trying to find out where the ball maybe went out of bounds.
Personal foul, offense, 15 yards from the end of the run.
Hey, G, G, G.
After the play, personal foul, offense.
Bad break here for Milton. He's able to complete that pass, make it second and short now with the penalty. Looks like it's going to be about third and 20 here.
Nickel 6 for 16, 74 yards. The one touchdown pass to Thornton. Now facing a third and 17. Eagles 1 for 7 on third downs in this game. Billings in motion, going to hand off to Moskowitz. He's going to get swallowed up right away by Cole Mullins, and it's going to be fourth down.
Nice job once again by Cole Mullins. Just a tough task right there to ask Luke Nickel to step back and try to complete a ball on third and 17 against this defense, the way they're rushing the passer tonight.
You know, not that anybody said it, but we started the game by talking about Mill Creek having been knocked out of the playoffs by Milton twice in the previous 4 years. And you just kind of got the sense, and again, not that anybody said it, but the Mill Creek really felt like they had a score to settle here after being eliminated by this Eagles team in 2018 and 2021.
Just that mindset sometimes that enough is enough and we're going to put our foot down. And in this case, we have all the weapons in our toolbox that we can get this job done. Just a real sense about this team. So businesslike with their talented players.
Let's check in with Autumn Johnson.
Hey, guys. I asked Mill Creek's head coach, Lev Lady, who's an unsung hero on this team? And with no
hesitation, he said Brendan Jenkins. He's a big receiver. He doesn't sub out. He will play 60 snaps a game, but most importantly, he's a leader. When Brendan talks, the room just gets quiet and listens. Coach said, I would hire him on my staff right now because of the way he treats people and the way he acts on and off the field. In fact, Coach put Brendan on a senior poster, and three middle school teachers asked if they would have Brendan sign it for him. And we're talking about 5 years removed away from middle school, you all, but that's just a true testament of his character and the impact he has on people as a role model.
Hey, good stuff, Autumn. Just a true, strong character kid, like his dad, just, you know, cut out of the same cloth, just superhuman beings. And, you know, you figure he's going to have himself a really good college football career somewhere.
Wearing his dad's number 12 when I played with Michael, very, very professional kind of player, a guy that was always in tune in his responsibility. And as I said, you have to keep your eye on those kind of players like Jenkins that kind of have gotten lost but has that talent, that skill set, and that size that you see him have.
Wyatt Smalley with the quarterback sack there for Milton brings up third down. It's increasingly apparent that Throgmorton's going to finish out this game at quarterback.
Hey.
10 plus yards per play on 34 snaps for Mill Creek tonight. You'll win a lot of games doing that. Throgmorton through to Wood. And you can see, and Throgmorton, and this is nothing against Throgmorton, you can just see the difference in the timing of the game. He's the backup quarterback. He doesn't take the first team reps in practice, so he doesn't work with these wide receivers as much. And it's apparent when you make that change in the game.
A step slow with his reaction to where he wants to go with the ball, but he's done a great job in coming in, as we talked about, especially in those first couple of throws, very sharp. But there's certain routes that young quarterbacks can throw when they're sleeping, and they're certain they have to mature to be able to throw.
Punt by Ulrich. Gonna hit it the 40 and rock it down the field. A 14-yard bounce down to the 26-yard line. But Throgmorton gets some really valuable experience tonight. Milton going back on offense with under 6 minutes to play in the third quarter and facing a large deficit at Lakewood Stadium.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
How much fun to be able to wear your pajamas out to the ball game. Back to live action here with under 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Closing in on what's going to be an historic night for Mill Creek. They are now just 17 minutes away from their first ever trip to the state championship game. They've been around 19 seasons. Shannon Jarvis started the program, brought Josh Lovelady along with him from South Gwinnett, where they were assistant coaches. Worked with the legendary T. McFerrin. Lovelady came over as the offensive line coach. Billings looks like he wants to throw a pass. Or, pardon me, that was a pass, not Billings. Yeah, it was Billings. Throwing a pass downfield and trying to connect, and it's incomplete.
Right there, trying to get the ball down the field. The real Parton.
Yeah.
Once again, trying that double pass. I've seen them try that a couple of times, once even to Luke Nickel.
They went through a tough spell back in 2000. They had five season-ending knee injuries, a couple of labrum injuries. The team captains, key players, had a losing season. The seniors on this year's team were sophomores that year, and not that they knew it, but they were kind of laying the groundwork, Wayne, for what they've been able to do this year, because a lot of sophomores got playing time in 2000 that they would not have ordinarily got. But because they had a bad season and injuries, it's kind of set the table for this great season in 2022.
Get that experience, get those guys to come together and get that brotherhood. And sometimes that's just how these teams explode. You try to keep them together from eighth, seventh, and eighth grade, and you just keep them in that tight bubble for a couple of years. You can come up with a special team.
First and 10, Nickel going up top. It is going to be intercepted, broken up. Greco nearly had the interception on the pass target to DeBron Gatling.
Showing you the speed here is Greco. When you're able to keep stride for stride with DeBron Gatling in great position, and that's the thing you love about Trayvon Greco. Even if the receiver catches the ball, he always seems to be in great position to make the play. This time almost coming up with the interception. The tight coverage there, really nowhere to fit that ball in to DeBron Gatling.
I know I've done this story before, but they were doing a 7-on-7 in Athens at the University of Georgia over the summer, and Will Muschamp was really impressed with what he saw from Greco. And just the more, every time we see Greco, and this is the third Mill Creek game that we've televised this year, every time we see him, he just gets better.
Definitely each and every snap that he can get. And as we talked about, a basketball player at heart, that lets you know those ball skills. He can see the ball. He's used to that timing. And he just seems a little bigger than they have him listed.
Yeah, he does. He looks big.
They got him listed at 175, and I'm not sure about that. He looks like maybe about 190 out there.
Third down and 8. Nickel might have got a face mask right there. He's going to run for a first down and slide at the 49. I thought they got a piece of his face mask. Did we have a flag down there? It was a 9-yard pickup.
AG losing contain on Nickel right there. Nickel can't fall asleep on the size and strength of Nickel. He's 6'2", 200 pounds. You can see one arm is not just going to pull him down.
Funny story about Luke Nickel. They're wearing their white helmets tonight, but last week against Grayson, they broke out their black helmets for the first time, and Luke was just having a spectacular game, just throwing darts all over the field, and he came over the sideline and told Coach Reeves, he said, man, I can really see out of this face mask. And Coach was like, why didn't you tell us before? He said, but that's
personal
just
foul, face mask, defense, 15-yard penalty. First down.
But Coach Reeves says that's just kind of the kid Luke Nickel is. He doesn't complain, you know.
Right here, you can see just losing him right there, and you can see the hand of AG going up in the face mask. But only a sophomore is Nickel, so big and bright future for Milton.
Yeah, he's going to be a really good one. I mean, you can even see on a night like tonight where they're just getting drilled, nothing good is really happening. You can see he still has poise. He's not panicked. That's a low throw, but I'm pretty sure Wyatt Nave would tell you he should have come up with that.
You can see that grittiness about Nick, who, and that willingness in this kind of game, being this, still throwing his body around as such a young player. So things aren't going your way in this kind of game, but the mental aspect for him seems to be totally engaged here. Good pocket, just a low ball. And Nave right there, you gotta come up with that catch for your quarterback.
Moskowitz gonna get stonewalled there at the line of scrimmage.
McDinnick, his defensive front, Bothwell, Maxey, those guys, they're just all out effort. They're not the biggest, more in that linebacker body. They're 225, 210, other than Bothwell, who's around 280. But they are effort guys. They just seem to have that knack to be able to get off blocks.
Yeah, they're not big-time college guys. Now, they do have college offers. Nick Denick right there, number 25, been offered by Stetson, Nick Maxey, North Greenville. But they're not big-time college football prospects, but, man, they play a great defensive line. Nickel bailing out of there and just gets rid of it.
Looks like on that play, Nickel was trying to set up a screen to the left and just nowhere to go with the ball. Did the smart thing, get the ball out of his hands. It's been tough sledding against this defense tonight. Not able to get anything going in the rush game, front through the running backs. Consistently finding themselves in second and third and long.
So fourth and 10 here from the 38. They keep the offense on the field. 37, actually. Short of the sticks, can Thornton get there? He's going to be close. Looks like they're going to spot him short. Looks like he's going to come up short.
Definitely looks about a half yard short right there. Good position to get him the ball and try to let him use his physicality and his size to pick it up. A good tackle, good job of coming out of secondary and holding short on that fourth down.
Yep. Needed 10, they got 9.5. So Mill Creek, ball goes over on downs to the Hawks. And that pretty much guarantees that we'll have a running clock in the fourth quarter, likely the last opportunity for Milton to have the ball here in this third quarter and cut the deficit below 30, which they would need to do to avoid the running clock. Kevin Mitchell in the game. Might see more Kevin Mitchell runs in the fourth quarter.
Couple of changes in that offensive line as well, as you can see. Some of the backups have entered the game. Waters, number 60 is in. Blanco, number 71.
Winner of this game appears to be Mill Creek. Will play the winner of the Colquitt County and Carrollton semifinal being played tonight in Moultrie. That game is not yet kicked off. But that will be the 7A championship matchup at Center Park Stadium next Saturday at 7 o'clock. Mitchell, run, getting bull rushed out of bounds. Clock continues to run. There you see Mill Creek's potential opponents in the championship game, Carrollton. They've never played the Trojans. Colquitt County, 1-3 all-time against the Packers. Mill Creek won the last matchup against Colquitt County. But Colquitt County knocked them out in the 2015 semifinals, 52-31.
That's love, lady, right now. This game is in hand, as you see, we see some backups in. One of the big keys, as we're going to talk about as that game comes upon us next week, is the health of Hayden Clark. We're not really sure if it just was a precautionary thing. We do see his left arm taped up there. If you see number 17.
Yeah, he's standing in the back of the huddle right now. Check in with John Nelson. Nelly, what's going on?
Well, we got the game coming up in 6A, and let's take a peek at the 6A bracket and show you how we got to the Final Four. Hughes and Rome coming up just around the corner, half hour after the conclusion of our game. On that left-hand side, it's Roswell and Gainesville. Roswell and Gainesville. Gainesville, Josh Niblett in his first season as head coach of the Red Elephants there at Bobby Gruen Field at City Park, really has turned that program around. Heath Webb, I think, was 5-5 in his last season there in Gainesville. A lot of folks are hearkening back to the days of Bruce Miller and the championships and the deep runs that they had. Roswell, the big win last week against Thomas County Central, where they were down early, came all the way back to win. Woodward Academy lost to Hughes last week. Matt, that one was tied early. Early on, and then Marist and Rome, I think that game was over in about an hour and a half, the way that that game ran. But you're looking at that right now, coming up in 6A. One of those on our air, the other we'll keep an eye on all night long.
And if Gainesville gets to the state championship game, if I'm not mistaken, it'll be their first since another guy who was in the news today, Deshaun Watson, was their quarterback. There's Deshaun Watson returning to the NFL after his suspension and will be the starting quarterback for the Cleveland Browns on Sunday.
A lot of eyes would be on that.
No doubt.
With his return, big return, even without the scandal for someone to come back and try to enter a game that hasn't played in almost
700 days.
Years.
That's, it's been 700 days.
You know, a lot of people, are on the scandal. I'm more on what he'll look like after missing basically 2 years of football.
He was certainly spectacular for Gainesville, leading them to a state championship. And now the Red Elephants are right there on the precipice of perhaps another state finals appearance. Bryce Thornton on the punt return. Strong return up to the 44-yard line. Just kind of showing you the heart of that young man right there, a guy that senior season hasn't been the best from a health standpoint, but he has battled through injuries to complete the season.
Truly a unicorn with his size and speed. Headed to Florida, so talented. As you saluted him early, for a guy that really had those little nagging injuries, where in today's high school, guys just go head on and lay up and go on to college. He came and still out there fighting in a game, willing to go play and return punts down 38 points.
Probably the final play of the third quarter right here. Keeper by Nickel. Luke Nickel. Like we said, he's not sliding. He's running back quarterback position like he's a fullback. Heading to the final 12 minutes at Lakewood Stadium. It's been all Mill Creek, just 12 minutes away from their first ever state championship game appearance, if they can hold on in the fourth.
Well, we've got a quick break in the action. Did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumber!
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons. Lighting up good business, so business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Buckle up, Georgia. We're just getting started on this Football Friday in Georgia, although we're heading to the fourth quarter in this 7A semifinal. We got another semifinal, 6A, coming up 30 minutes following the conclusion of this one, following our special semifinal edition of Recruiting 2022, as number one Langston Hughes takes on number four Rome. Got a running clock here as we start the fourth quarter. Up top, touchdown catch by Mark Esley.
Mark Esley down the field, big play. We know him for that. Cool customer, Luke Nickel right there, fumbling the snap. The line doing a good job of giving him time to get the ball off the ground, as you see. Kept his head up, remembered where his receiver was. Backups on defense for Mill Creek. Marco Lawler. Lawler is in there for James Patterson. Just mistimed his jump right there, trying to knock the ball down. Touchdown, Milton.
40-yard touchdown pass from Nickel to Esley. If there's going to be a comeback, that's the first step.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Record-breaking winds and rainfall defined the area last night as an unexpected...
Hey, Danny. Y'all make it through the storm last night?
Don't worry, I'm on the way.
Let's go to work, Lucky.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance. We
are
a farm
bureau. Our number one priority is protecting our players. That's why we're writing new rules for the sport and developing innovative educational tools to protect our athletes. This is player protection. This is high school football.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathe in your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
45-14, Milton scores their first touchdown since the final minute of the second quarter on a 40-yard touchdown pass. Luke Nickel to Mark Esley.
Bad snap. Luke Nickel keeping his head about him in the game, going deep to his big play receiver, and Esley to get on the board once again.
Mark Esley, who started his high school career, if you will, at Wheeler, then Westlake, now here at Milton. Real speedster. Gets a highlight here on semifinal night.
Dynamic player, only a junior. And as we talked about, other than his size, he's as dynamic as you want in a receiver.
There's Mikel Wood. Haven't called his name since he scored three touchdowns in the first half. Wood on the return. Driven out of bounds just beyond the 35. They'll spot it at 37, and that's where Mill Creek will go on offense. 30-yard return for Mikel Wood.
With this running clock, as you know, Mill Creek, you want to come out, just put a couple of first downs together, not really focus on scoring. Definitely still want to get Shane Throgmart and keep him in that groove, as we talked about with Hayden Clark. We don't really know the significance of his injury. So you want to kind of continue to call plays that Throgmorton can stay involved in the game.
So Wood has 65 yards in returns, and he also has 151 in receiving, thereabouts, rough numbers, but over 200 yards of all-purpose offense for Mikel Wood tonight. Moskowitz on the run, a couple of yards right there. And I mean, I think at this point, people might say, well, why aren't they throwing the ball? Well, you want to finish the game strong. The chances of you coming back and winning this game by dropping back and throwing it on every play are slim to none. So finish the game strong, run the ball, break off a run, then go from there.
You definitely have to still stay within your identity.
Yeah.
You can't just bring up a new offense at this point because you're down and you're desperate. Nice run there by Conway right there, Bryce Conway. Oak Creek has a lot of subs in the game right now.
Yeah, Bryce Conway, and I think I said Moskowitz, Bryce Conway running the ball here. And off the hands of their intended target right there. Getting some of their deeper reserves in the game, guys that aren't even necessarily on the two deep. That's Colin Spahn, junior wide receiver. So third down and seven.
And as you was alluding to, in these situations, typically you just want to run the ball, but not knowing Clark's true injury, you may have to have a little offense, a little practice, live action here for Throgmorton for those kind of plays next week, even though it will be with the number one guy.
Mm-hmm.
You still want to keep him in that rhythm.
Conway, another run. First down for Conway. Breaks out of there. Being chased and finally caught at the 28-yard line.
What I like about this is how he ended this place. Bryce Conway, as he saw the guys about to run it down here, good physical run in between, behind his pads. Just love how he recognizes, no, I'm not going to let you push me out of bounds. And I know it's a running clock, but I'm saying those still, you have to imagine yourself in real games
right.
When those things happen. You still don't want to lose all your fundamentals.
32-yard run by Conway. And this is a big reward for those guys who are the second teamers, for them to get in there and get a chance to play in the semifinal. Pass is complete. Down to the 17-yard line it goes. Kyle Pinckney making the grab.
Just a stop route. Nice job there. Throgmorton getting the ball out of his hand quick. Just a three-step throw. Get the ball out to Pinckney out on the edge. These guys are just as important to this team. These are the guys that you have to practice against. They're the ones who get you ready. And it's just always good to be able to go out as a player or starter and create a chance for other guys to get out on the field.
Throgmorton came in relief when Clark got hurt in the second quarter. Looked like he maybe had offsides there, but no whistle. That's Conway with a short run. Looked like Ja'Cory Stewart came flying in off the edge, but they didn't blow a whistle.
And this defense didn't show it tonight, but what a season they had. Came into this game, 54 sacks. When you get to that kind of, you think it's a misprint, 17 interceptions.
How about the story of Ja'Cory Stewart?
Ja'Cory Stewart and that story.
He just picked up his first collegiate offer this week. Ole Miss offered the junior linebacker. Been working with Justin Miller, the former Clemson standout, played for the New York Jets, and Miller a part of the coaching staff here for Milton. And, you know, Ja'Cory arrived, a transfer from Langston Hughes, just so raw.
Delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
And Justin Miller told Ben Reeves, you know what, I'll take this guy. I'll take this guy, I'll work with this guy.
And it's shaped him into an outstanding player that you have great expectations for next year. And those freak athletes, possibly playing out of position.
Yeah.
You know, when you think about it, maybe more in the frame of a strong safety. But dynamic season for him, 5 sacks, 16 tackles for a loss he came into this game with. A lot of young bodies for this Milton Eagles team.
Conway, Parton making the tackle for Milton right there. Parton with now 8 tackles in this game to lead the Milton defense. And what a champ. And first of all 4 coaches that we talked to this week, them giving their time in a busy preparation week to help us be ready to do our job. But what a champ Coach Ben Reeves. We're talking to him on a Zoom call in his car with his wife and his newborn son, Riley, sitting in the back seat. So we really appreciate all these coaches that work with us on a weekly basis and spend time with us, going through their team, giving us their thought process on the game coming up. Next week, we'll be talking to Josh again. Josh Lovelady. Looking forward to that. That's Conway with the run, and then the tackle by Caleb Moran, and then helps him up.
It's good to see him back in that action. We saw him leave a little earlier, nursing that shoulder. The starter's still out here for the Eagles. Owen Phillips, a lot of guys just had an outstanding season for this team. And this linebacker core, as you was alluding to, just the numbers are just all across the board.
Yeah, this is going to be a new kicker. Brady Lane's going to take this field goal attempt. He's 2 for 2 on the season with a long of 31. This is 39.
Timeout. Mill Creek.
So Mill Creek calls the timeout before the 39-yard field goal attempt, icing their own kicker. Less than 5 to go in this one. We'll step aside.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being. Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at ExpressGA.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Get you back to Matt and Wayne in just a bit. 4:56 to go in the fourth in game number one of two at Lakewood. Game number two coming up in 6A. It is Rome and the juggernaut that is nationally ranked Langston Hughes. Say that 10 times fast. All the other games short of two kicked off at 7:30. We have pregame fireworks, Matt, in AAA with Sandy Creek and Carver Atlanta. The Sandy Creek players met the Carver Atlanta players the second that they hit the track in Tyrone. Carver Atlanta tried to plant the flag at the 50. That's what we got here on Semifinal Friday. Back to you.
Thank you, Nelly. Got to watch out about that planting the flag stuff. You get a lot of fights started that way. Lane's field goal attempt is through. Snuck it in the left corner of the uprights and the goalpost. How about that? Right there in the corner where the crossbar meets the uprights, and they level him in the celebration.
And he's celebrating, just happy to get it in.
Thirty-nine-yard kick here by Brady Lane. Just snuck it in there.
Coach Lovelady.
Yeah. That's the way you do it.
Make me look like a genius. That's what you do. Nice job by Lane getting that ball in. And that's, you just love that energy, the happiness. You were thinking a blowout, kicking up that would make everybody just run over casual. That shows you how much people and how much these players are still in the game.
And people might be wondering, well, why are you kicking a field goal when you have such a big lead? It's because if this is a different game, and the score is tight, that's what you would do in this situation. So you do in the situation what you would normally do. You don't play the game any differently.
And with another game on the schedule, yep. You never know who has to go in next week.
That's right. Bryce Thornton standing deep for the Eagles to return this kick. Looks like Camden Pouzis is going to kick off this time. So all three kickers getting a chance to exercise their leg tonight. Thornton all the way up to the 34-yard line on what might have been the final kick return of his career. And Ben Reeves could not sing the praises of Bryce Thornton enough. He said that Bryce Thornton might be the greatest high school football player he's ever coached, including LT Overton, the 5-star, number one rated defensive lineman who reclassified and signed early and now playing as a freshman for the Texas A&M Aggies.
Just that dynamic of a player is Bryce Thornton. I think a lot of that just comes from coach being around him and seeing the dedication a lot of times that you miss out on. Guy that really stands out, not just as a physical talent, but as a player, as far as a leadership role.
Milton, next level. Got to have LT Overton at the top of that list. Joe Charleston, great safety, who's now at Missouri. Paul Teo at Georgia Tech. Jordan Yates, love to watch him. Quarterback led him to the state title. He's now at Sam Houston State after starting at Georgia Tech. And Jack Nickel, Luke's brother, who's now at Michigan State. And Luke's out of the ball game. Dylan Warren, the junior, has now come in to finish off this game at quarterback. And that's Moskowitz on the run for the first down.
Scott Moskowitz, outstanding senior season. It's one of those one cut downhill, as you can see on this play. No real dancing for him. He's just taking reservations. Who would like to get on the 22 party train right there?
First and 10 after the 18-yard run by Moskowitz. And, you know, Ben Reeves labeled Moskowitz the closer this season. And typically he's come in a closing situation, kind of like a closer in baseball, to finish off the game, to get the win. And unfortunately, he's in the closing role tonight on the losing side, but he's had a great senior year, rushed for over 1,100 yards. Low snap, Warren going to have to cover it. And a really good job by the offensive line this year, too. They lost a Power 5 offensive line. Every one of their offensive linemen last year, Wayne, are playing college football today. They had a brand new offensive line, went through a lot of bumps and bruises early in the season, but rallied in the second half of the season to finish strong.
Just a great core of linemen as well, as the coach talked about. Not a whole bunch of D1 prospects, but as a unit, just had a solid season. Gritty and fight for each other.
Moskowitz stonewalled at the line of scrimmage. Luke Nickel will be back. He's got two more seasons to go. Finished up his sophomore season tonight, leading the Eagles to the state semifinals. Luke finished 9-for-21, 128. Couple of touchdown passes. Got sacked 4 times. He's a tough kid.
And has a lot of this young talent coming back with him. Yeah. Of course, Gatling, Esley, Ryan G as well. So he should have a smile on his face. Maybe not tonight, no. But tomorrow when he realizes that a lot of his teammates will be back with him. That continuity is what you talked about that breeds championship.
Got a lot of seasoning this year as underclassmen playing. Nickel will be a junior next year. And all those guys you mentioned, they'll be seniors. Except for G, he'll be a junior too. So good things coming to Milton next year. Good things coming for Mill Creek tonight. It's on to the state championship game for the Hawks for the first time in program history. 13th win of the season. That ties the 2015 and 2016 teams for the most in program history. And Mill Creek's got one more game to go, and they'll face either Carrollton or Colquitt County for the 7A state championship next Saturday night at Center Park Stadium.
Came out early in a blazing fire type way. I mean, the way they started off on both sides, scoring five touchdowns right off the bat, to put all the pressure on to Milton. Coach Lovelady, you got the sense as we talked to him, he has the hand. And when he has the hand, you got to play it to win. He has the team that he feels is very capable of taking home the trophy, the personality of the players as well.
Mill Creek now 13-1 on the season with a resounding 48-14 victory over Milton here in the 7A semifinals. The Eagles finished the year at 10-4 in Ben Reeves' first season as the head coach. But a long time coming for this Mill Creek team. Like we said, when the night started, the most talented team in Mill Creek history, and they have the results to back that up. All right, let's send it to Autumn Johnson. She's standing by with head coach Josh Lovelady.
We may have to have a TV timeout for me. Damn, I catch my breath.
Coach, I mean, the first championship appearance for this program, what does that sound like to you?
That's wonderful. It really is. Brings a lot of emotion. Being here 19 years, the foundation we started a long time ago, and all the guys, Hawks before now, all the hours put in, and these guys bring it to this day, it's awesome.
It took a little bit of everyone. I mean, on the defensive end and offensive end, it wasn't just one guy out there. What's it like coaching this group?
Well, I think it was one of the most complete halves I've ever been associated with. I mean, you got block kicks, you got kickoffs that are end zones, special teams, offense, defense, stops. I tell you what, this ball club, whatever stars it is, it doesn't matter. It's about they love each other, and it's about just unselfishness, which is hard to find now in these days.
And the guy that set the tone from the jump was Mikhail Wood. I mean, he is our Georgia Cotton Commissioner Player of the Game. What can you say about him?
Tremendous. You know, for a buck 40, heck, he can sit there and fly, has great hands. There's a great connection between him and Hayden. Obviously, some great balls, but him getting that after it, it's awesome.
Well, I got to talk to him. Thank you so much. Let's toss it to Matt real quick as we get the Georgia Cotton Commissioner Player of the Game.
Yeah, Mikhail Wood, what a performance by Mikhail Wood tonight. Over 200 yards of all-purpose offense, five catches for 151, and three touchdowns. Just a spectacular performance by Mikhail, and we'll send it right back to Autumn, standing by with Mikhail Wood.
Thank you so much. Yes, with the Georgia Cotton Commissioner, Player of the Game, Mikhail Wood. I mean, are we even surprised? Three touchdown receptions from you. You set the tone for this team. What kind of zone were you in tonight?
I can't say I was the only one in the zone. I say the whole team came out here, did what they were supposed to do. So, yes, ma'am.
The whole team got it done, and now this team is headed to its first ever championship appearance. What was the journey like to get here?
It was a rough journey, you know, losing to Buford. But we always going to bounce back, as you can see, going to state, you know what I'm saying?
It's your senior year. One more to get it done. How do you finish the job?
Win the state championship. That's it. Let's do it.
All right, well, good luck on the rest of the way, and great play from you.
Yes, ma'am. Appreciate it.
All right, let's head back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Autumn. How about the performance by Mikhail Wood tonight? And, you know, you get to the state championship game as a senior. Does it get better than that?
I mean, big plays down the field against this top-notch secondary is what you have to do. Those touchdowns were against D1 talent cornerbacks and safeties.
Well, a special semifinal edition of Recruiting 2022 is coming up, and then we've got Langston Hughes and Rome after that. In the meantime, Hannah Gooden's going to take over in studio after this timeout. Mill Creek throttles Milton 48-14 to win this 7A semifinal, going to the state championship game for the first time ever. Congratulations to Josh Lovelady and the Hogs. A lot more football coming up in the moments and hours ahead. Stick with us. Football Friday in Georgia. We're really just getting started.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMCs support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
To GPB's coverage of the GHSA semifinals. I'm Hannah Gooden. We just wrapped up game one where Mill Creek beat Milton 48-14 to advance to the GHSA championships next week for the first time ever at Center Park Stadium. Game number two of our doubleheader is coming up next, featuring the 6A matchup between Rome and Langston Hughes. The first matchup ever between those two. In the meantime, we're going to introduce you to some of the top athletes that will be playing on the field in that one, as well as all of the latest recruiting news around the state. That's on Recruiting 2022, and it starts right now.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Welcome to GBB Sports Recruiting 2022, the non-commercial variety.
Commercial-free zone.
Commercial-free zone, because we got a game to talk about, and it's going to come up after we stop talking about it and what else has been going on. It is the second semifinal coming up. Man, semifinal weekend, that's just blows your mind.
It does blow my mind, and a semifinal doubleheader. Hope you're enjoying it. Coming up in the midst of this doubleheader, Rome four stars to Phylon Green is one of the top defensive linemen in the entire country. He's one of 10 players from Georgia who are committed to Clemson in the class of 2023. And later on tonight, in the next few minutes, he's going to be leading Rome's defense against that Langston Hughes high-powered offense that's averaging 55 points per game. But before he does all that, you'll see his conversation with our Hannah Gooden.
You know, first things first, what's important? You got to talk to Hannah before you play, and that's what we've got to do here. Lead story has to do with the Western Frontier and a coaching change, things coming together. It's a merry flipmas for the folks on the plane.
Yeah, we got a lot of flips, got a lot of decommitments this week. Let's start with this one, and this is Darren Reed, Carver Columbus, four-star defensive lineman, flips from LSU to Auburn. He had been committed to LSU since July 4th, but then had taken 5 unofficial visits to nearby Auburn since then, so the writing was kind of on the wall. He actually made this flip before Hugh Freeze was hired.
Okay.
Reed is rated the number 6 defensive lineman in the On3 recruiting rankings. Auburn now has the 11th ranked class in the SEC, and Reed becomes the highest ranked defensive player in the 2023 class. Finished his career with Carver, totaling 91 tackles, 31 TFL, and 18 quarterback sacks.
So from the Western Frontier and a merry flitmas, let's go to Gwinnett County.
Can you say pipeline?
Pipeline.
Another Grayson Starr commits to LSU. This time it's sophomore cornerback Jalen Bell. He becomes the 4th Rams player to commit to the Tigers this year. Bell chose LSU over 15 other offers, including Miami and Florida State, committing just 6 days after the Bayou Bengal Tigers offered. He joins Grayson, 2023 star safety Michael Daugherty. He's committed to LSU. 2024 DB Zion Ferguson. He's committed to LSU. And former Rams star, 2024 athlete JoJo Stone, who's now at Hughes, he's committed to LSU as well.
I feel like I should do a Joe Dean impression when you're talking about LSU.
Bengals.
Next story. We're sticking with Grayson, but it's because of a decom.
Yeah, this is 3-star senior edge rusher R.J. Johnson. Decommits from Georgia State. He had been committed to the Panthers back in August, but announced his decommitment on Twitter this week, tweeting, quote, "Wanted anywhere I'm needed." That might be Northern Illinois. Johnson will reportedly visit the Huskies next weekend. His original top 5 before committing to the Panthers included Georgia State, of course, Minnesota, West Virginia, East Carolina, and Grambling State.
From Gwinnett to DeKalb, Illinois, possibly. Next story, another decomp.
Another decomp here. Shiloh 3-star corner Bryce Pollock decommits from Pitt. Pollock had been committed to the Panthers since early June, but changed his mind a week after being offered by NC State. Told 24/7 Sports that Mississippi State was also in the mix, as was Indiana and Duke. Pollock took an unofficial visit to Starkville when the Bulldogs hosted Georgia. He has 32 other offers, including Michigan State, North Carolina, and Ole Miss, all of whom he took official visits to over the summer.
From Gwinnett County, we go to the Southern Crescent for another decomp.
Can we say decomp?
Yes, decomp.
How many times can we say it? We're saying it a lot. Stars Mill 3-star tight end Josh Pfeiffer decommits from Liberty, at least for now. 6'5", 225 senior, had been committed to the Flames since July, and his change of heart comes in the same week that coach Hugh Freeze changed his mind about Liberty and took Auburn. However, it sounds like he might still end up there at Liberty. Reading between the lines, it appears he's waiting to see who the Flames are going to hire as their next head coach, see what assistant coaches remain. He has 10 other offers, including 3 other FBS offers, Western Kentucky, Air Force, and Army.
Decomp is like the candy man for high school football. Next story, we got a flip.
A lot of it going around here in the month of December. Georgia lands a big flip for one of the fastest receivers in the 2023 class, Converse Texas Judson four-star wide receiver Anthony Evans changes his mind on his commitment to Oklahoma and chooses the Bulldogs instead. Evans had been committed to the Sooners since August, but took an official to Georgia for the Dogs win over Tennessee, and that apparently is when the wheels were set in motion for this flip. He had also been committed to Arkansas earlier in his recruiting process.
And so now for our final story, the folks in Statesboro are going nice.
Nice pickup here for Georgia Southern. It is Niceville, Florida, three-star tight end Jaden Michael, 6'4", 231 senior, chose the Eagles over 12 other offers, including UAB, who this week hired as their head coach
Trent Dilfer. He's a game manager.
Yes, 14 career, got a Super Bowl ring, though.
Uh-huh.
14 career games. Michael had 21 catches for 223 yards and one touchdown. He is the only tight end commit and the fifth player out of Florida in the Eagles' 17 total commitments in the 2023 class.
So that's all the news in the top of the show. We've got a game coming up once again after we stop talking. It's one of the semifinals here around the state on this Friday night, and it's going to be a fun one.
It is going to be a great one. It's going to be the Rome Wolves back in the state semifinals since the first time when they got upset by Warner Robins, ended their 40-game winning streak. It's been a while, 2018, and Langston Hughes, of course, they're back in the semifinals for the second straight year. They've won 26 of the last 27 games. Their only loss, last second loss to Buford in the 6A final a year ago.
Yeah, and so we got a lot of talent. We could have a show on its own. Here's a guy who was so great they named the high school after him.
Yes, Bo Hewley, four-star and ESPN number 10 offensive tackle, committed to Georgia over 21 other offers, including Florida State, Auburn, Miami, and Georgia. Got my vote for the GPB All-State team.
Mine too.
Yours too. Hewley had been committed to the Bulldogs for over 14 months, has been, not past tense, but has been. But Auburn has recruited him hard.
Oh, yes, they have.
Auburn has recruited most of the Langston Hughes school body, student body, very hard. They want those guys. Hewley was at Jordan-Hare Stadium.
Academic bowl guy, come to Auburn.
Yeah, he was at Jordan-Hare Stadium again a couple of weeks ago when the Tigers beat Western Kentucky, along with another strong contingent of Hughes players. But he says he's not going to sign, even though he's been committed for 14 months, not going to sign until February.
Okay.
So that perhaps leaves the door open, gives some Auburn fans some reason for optimism, gives Georgia fans a reason to fret.
I think this is safe to say that this guy was also on our All-State team.
He was indeed. Jelani Thurman, ESPN four-star, number one tight end in the nation, committed to Ohio State over 28 other offers, including his three official visits, which were Alabama, Michigan State, and Auburn. Spectacular talent that coach Daniel Boone Williams calls a unicorn.
Mm-hmm.
At tight end, he reminds me a lot personally of Eric Gilbert,
okay,
who started Marietta, National Player of the Year. He's now at Georgia because he's too big for DBs to cover. He's too fast for linebackers.
Matchup problem.
Yes, he is indeed. Equally as talented playing defensive end. He's reportedly taken six unofficial visits to Auburn this season. So he's another guy that could be on flip watch.
And I think here's someone else that would probably safe to say was on the All-State team.
He is. I think he's going to be. We haven't released it yet, but he got my vote.
Safe to say mine too.
He also got my vote for Offensive Player of the Year
for
the entire state. Four-star, on-three recruiting, number eight quarterback, 27-plus offers, including Auburn, Arkansas, Miami, West Virginia,
there
and Vanderbilt.
Offer air
and I ask you, what has air not done?
Fire.
What's more
earth,
important than air?
Fire, breathing, water,
well, air
oxygen.
Has right at 3,600 passing
grass.
Yards, 49 touchdowns, four interceptions, just four interceptions. That's a plus 45 touchdown to interception ratio. He's completed
air,
close
fire,
to 71%
water.
Of his passes, and he runs a Panthers offense that is averaging, wait for it, 55 points per game, 26-2 as a starting quarterback, and he is considered one of Coach Freeze's top recruiting priority
and a lefty
as
QB.
He takes over the Auburn.
They can drive 55. Next stop, how about a little love in the secondary?
Four-star, rivals number nine safety, Terrence Love. This is one guy that Auburn doesn't have to flip because he's been committed to the Tigers since April. In fact, he's kind of been the Pied Piper, leading all those Hughes players down there to watch Auburn all season long. He committed to Auburn over 38 other offers, including Florida, Miami, Georgia Tech, 53 tackles, two interceptions, and as Hughes Hughes goes deeper and deeper into the playoffs. He's playing more and more wide receiver.
As you should.
8 catches, 3 touchdowns, 23-plus yards per catch average. He will be playing on offense here tonight.
How about a target for Aaron Nolan?
Here's another one. Robert C.J. Lockhart, ESPN 4-star wide receiver, committed to Jackson State.
A good get
over
for
4 Prime. Other offers, including Maryland and Colorado, has bounced back this season after missing his entire junior season when he suffered a knee injury in spring practice. That cost him a chance last year to be on the field when the Panthers made their run to the state finals. Took his official visit to Jackson State about 6 weeks ago. Took an unofficial visit to Georgia Tech back in April. They nicknamed him SRT, as in Dodge Charger SRT.
Well, you just
supercharged.
Yeah, well, you just hope he lasts for a while because they're stopping production of those things. And Horton hears from who? The
North Heel? Carolina.
Horton hears from the Heels. I got it figured out.
But maybe Miami.
Oh, okay.
But maybe Miami, too. ESPN 3-star defensive lineman, 32 offers other than the one that he committed to North Carolina.
Oh.
His other two finalists were UCF and Auburn. But, hey, Miami creeping back into the mix here. Mm-hmm. Took an unofficial visit to Miami in October, which triggered a flurry of 24/7 Sports crystal ball predictions that he was going to flip to the Hurricanes. That hasn't happened yet. He has 105 tackles on the season as a D tackle. That's hard to do. 9 TFL, 3 sacks, 9 quarterback hurries.
Cannot have that football.
This might be the deepest and most talented defensive line in the entire state. He's one of 6 guys on the defensive line who have 80-plus tackles on the season.
Fancy TV graphic time, and we could probably do this for a while.
We could. We could make the whole show about Langston Hughes, but we're not going to for the sake of brevity. We'll go with 5 guys here. Amir Glenn, Rivals 3-star, 6 offers, including Georgia Tech, North Carolina, UCF, 109 tackles on the season. Dontrell Glover, maybe the next Bo Cooley. Not quite as big as Bo. He's 6'3", 290. He's just a little kid. 5 offers, including UCF and Georgia Tech. How about Jaden Barnes?
How about
Jaden
Barnes?
The radar has offers from Western Kentucky, James Madison, and Tennessee Tech. He has 34 catches for 968 yards. John, when you do the math, that's over 30 yards.
There's no math on this show.
That's over 30 yards per reception with 14 touchdowns. Jediah Willoughby, offered by Nebraska, and Morehouse, 6 touchdown catches. And Ja'Kale Middlebrook, kid to watch, 9 offers. Middle Tennessee, Western Kentucky, FAU among them. I'll remember that he was the Georgia Cotton Commission player of the game, and we saw Hughes right here on GPB 5 weeks ago.
Check.
And in the second half of the season, nearly 1,300 yards rushing, 17 touchdowns in just half of the season.
Not bad. Flip side to the visitors, and we're going to go to the all-name team.
Yeah, this guy's on the all-name team, Stephylan Green. 4-star, on 3 recruiting, number 7 D lineman, committed to Clemson, over 23 other offers, including Georgia and Ohio State. So he's serious.
Yes.
Serious here about this recruitment.
Yes.
Coach John Reed calls him explosive, powerful, very twitchy, sub 4.5 speed in the 40.
4.5 sub?
Yeah.
Defensive lineman.
Likely DN in the 3-4 defense. Another in a long line of great defensive linemen who played for Reed at Rome. 59 tackles, 13 TFL, 10 quarterback sacks, even has 2 interceptions. Part of an impressive Clemson 2023 class of Georgia high school players. We'll talk more about them in a moment. Includes Vic Burley. They're the top 2 defensive linemen in the state. They're both going to Clemson.
Flip side of the ball and Martavius Collins.
Yeah, junior, 4-star, ESPN number 5 tight end.
Seam route, good
committed
luck
to Bama, over 17 other offers, including Auburn. You will see him playing all over the field tonight. We'll even pop over on the defensive side of the ball, play some DN. Future is likely as a more traditional attached tight end at the next level, or lining up in the backfield at the sniffer position.
Sniffer?
H-back.
Thank you.
Yeah. Could be really a good night for the Wolves. If he's a big-time factor in the passing game tonight, could spell success for the Wolves.
So how about some height in the secondary?
This guy, too, is a two-way star. Martell Height, ESPN 4-star corner, committed to Vandy after originally committed to Louisville, over 4 other offers. Got the speed to match up with this talented Hughes team, which is like a track team.
Mm-hmm.
Will play major snaps on both sides of the ball. Coach Reed believes that he could be a difference maker for his team tonight. 34 catches, team leading 10 touchdown receptions, also has 3 interceptions, 2 block kicks, and 3 defensive touchdowns this season.
A couple of other guys that you have in your full screen spot shadow.
Alto Moore.
Hit the high notes for you at linebacker.
He will. And the low notes. He'll hit all the notes.
There
Junior, hit anything that moves. He's their leading tackler. 92 tackles, 55 solo, 10 TFL, 2 INT. Offers include Michigan State, Georgia State, and Liberty. Reese Fountain, their quarterback. Offered by Georgia Southern, Samford, and SEMO. Got better after the team's only loss this season, which was to Carrollton, which, by the way, is in the 7A semifinal.
I've heard,
tonight,
yes. Yeah.
At Colquitt County. Uh-huh. 29 yards passed, 2,900 yards passing, pardon me. 28 touchdowns, just 4 interceptions. Hasn't shown dual-threat quarterback ability this season, but Coach Reed says, like his former quarterback, Knox Kadem, who led them to two state championships, he has the ability to do it. And Justin J.T. Terrell, junior edge rusher, he lines up inside, plays nose for Rome right now. Offered by Liberty, he was the game MVP last week in the Wolves' quarterfinal win over Marist.
What you said. And we're officially in a no-dilly-no-dally zone, so we're going to get right to it. Time to catch up with the all-name team. Time to catch up with the interview of the stars, Hannah Gooden and Stephylin Green.
Hey, guys. Today I am joined by Rome senior defensive lineman Stephylin Green. Stephylin, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
You had 24 offers, including finalists Alabama, Georgia, Ohio State, Tennessee, Ole Miss, but you ultimately decided to commit to Clemson. Why did you choose the Tigers?
I took my OV, my official visit in June, and I just felt, it just felt like home. They big on education and stuff like that. They're always the top finalist. So I knew, and my mama already wanted me to go there when we took the visit, so.
Well, when it comes to education, what do you plan to study?
Probably engineering, mechanic, being a mechanic.
So smart kid too. So you joined defensive lineman Vic Burley and linebacker Jamal Anderson in the 2023 Clemson class, all top defensive prospects out of the state of Georgia. What attracted you out of state?
Well, Clemson was my last offer. And they was big on education. Everybody else was offering me about just because they weren't really checking in on the education part, and Clemson made sure my education was high enough for them, so I like that. So that's why I ultimately went with Clemson.
Well, the smarts is very evident. What kind of player is Clemson getting in you?
A hard-working player, a determined player, smart player, all above, all-around type of player.
So the Tigers are looking to replace a lot of talent on the defensive front. What has head coach Dabo Swinney and company said to you about next season?
They will build something great, and I've been seeing it and stuff. And I went to a couple of games, and I like what I saw. So, and he talked about, I'm going to have a little offensive package too. So that's going to be fun.
You still have some unfinished business to do before you leave high school. You're playing in the semifinals against Langston Hughes this week. What is it going to take to get past them and head to the championship game?
I feel like their offense is pretty good. That's why they've been winning games. But I feel like our defense and our confidence in each other, we're gonna be good. I feel like our defense can hold up and stop the run and pass and get pressures on the QB to stop them and win that game.
With the season winding down, looking back on your senior year, what are you most proud of?
All the hard work we put in for this. We've been practicing since January. So a lot of hard work has been put into this. The coaches, Coach Reed, Coach Hudson, the whole defensive staff, the whole offensive staff, we've been working. So we built for this. So, yeah.
Well, Stephylin, good luck in the semifinals and your future at Clemson. We cannot wait to watch you continue your football career. Thank you so much for your time today.
All right, thank you for having me.
So they're getting all the above.
I like that kid. I like his personality and can't wait, like Hannah said, I can't wait to see him play at the next level. Clemson got him a good one. They got a lot of good ones out of the state of Georgia in this
week. Yeah, well, when you got a coaching staff that's plugged in the way that it is, that's what's going to happen. All right, once again, no dilly, no dally zone. We're just going to go ahead and wind it up and finish it up with... Make that kid an offer.
Trust me. Make that kid an offer.
We got a lot of them to wrap it up this week. All right, so who's first on the list? Oh, first on the list, we go to Walton High School.
Let's do it.
Hit it.
Let's show them this. Make that kid an offer. We start with Walton running back Makari Botterford. Rushed for 113 yards, 21 carries in the Raiders' 52-27 quarterfinal loss at Carrollton. Last week on GPB, finishes junior year, 1,587 rushing yards, 20 touchdowns, 7 100-yard rushing games. Does have an offer from UMass. You know what? That kid needs more offers. Make Makari Botterford more offers.
Next stop, one of the teams we're going to see in a bit.
Yeah, Langston Hughes center. Aiden Watkins played on the defensive side of the ball last couple of years. Woo. Seemed demolished the quarterback there. 77
to
total
tackle
tackles.
Him.
Now his job is to protect the quarterback. His uncle is offensive line coach Rokevious Watkins, who played in South Carolina and in the NFL. Aiden Watkins,
make him an offer. Paulding County's next up. Go north.
Senior running back Jalen Poe ended the season as 7A scoring leader, 22 touchdowns, 1,500 total yards. Had a big game against Kennesaw State. Has no offers. Jalen Poe,
make that kid an offer. Kennesaw Mountain, first time Bethlehem Christian Academy.
Yeah, Joshua Adams, career stats, 2,844 rushing yards, 41 touchdowns,
Catch
60
him.
Tackles.
Good luck.
Joshua Adams,
make that kid an offer. Next stop, Ellaville in Sly County.
And Carson Westbrook, 11 career interceptions, 12 PBUs, 133 tackles, 4.0 GPA. Make Carson Westbrook an offer.
What he said, Darren Alford is the head coach down there. They're in a semifinal. Next up, Alexander.
And Jaden McCoy, running back, 344 receiving yards, 37 catches, 4 touchdowns. Hard-working team player, Jaden McCoy.
Make that kid an offer. Go to Cedar Shoals in Athens. What's up?
Nizer Mitchell, career stats, 55 tackles, 9 TFL, 2.5 sacks. Plays for the Jags of Cedar Shoals. Nizer Mitchell, make that kid an offer.
What he said then, Maynard Jackson, last
Maynard
stop.
Maynard Jackson, he was a great mayor, and they got a great offensive lineman, Urshad Rembert, region 6-5A, second team all region last year. This year he's first time, and he says he likes watching football. Guess what, Urshad? So do I.
Yes.
Urshad Rembert, make that kid an offer.
So we're gonna follow Urshad's advice and watch some football, because we got the second semifinal up now.
Another great show, guys. Thanks for watching Recruiting 2022. We can't wait to see these kids excel at the next level next season. Coming up next on GPB is our second game of the day. It's the 6A semifinal game between Rome and Hughes. This will be the very first meeting between the two programs. So let's bring in my buddy John Nelson. And John, let's take a look at these brackets.
Mm-hmm. Lightning round, yeah? All right, so let's take a peek. All right, so let's start with 6, and we'll show you what's going on here. We got our game coming up. So the 6A bracket, this is the right-hand side matchup here. Left-hand side is Roswell and Gainesville, and this is pretty much going to be kicking off. So simultaneous action. Roswell was down early to Thomas County. Central came back for the win last week. We had Coach Pruitt on the post-game show. Gainesville, fantastic season as they are trying to regain all of the glory that they had last time when Bruce Miller was head coach. So Roswell, Gainesville, Hughes, and Rome in 6A, Ham.
We have the GHSA semifinal doubleheader for you today. Our first game was the 7A matchup between Mill Creek and Milton, where the Hawks won it 48-14. And John, the Cotton Commission player of the game, Mikhail Wood, he was the star of the show. 5 receptions, 151 yards,
30 yards a catch.
Touchdowns. Unbelievable. Take us through this bracket.
Yep, Mill Creek and Milton, you saw here on Football Fridays. Right now, I'll give you a scoring update. Carrollton leading Colquitt County early second quarter at the Hogpen in Moultrie, 7-0. Those winners meet last on championship weekend.
And let's go to 5A, where Dutchtown is making its first ever semifinal appearance against Ware County. And Cartersville is facing Warner Robins. Now, those two, John, are used to playing each other in the playoffs.
They certainly are. Left-hand side scoring update. Ware County's leading 17-0 early second quarter in Waycross. Cartersville and Warner Robins. Warner Robins is leading that one 10-3 early in the second quarter.
You want to keep going, John? You want to show us 4A?
Keep going. Here we go. Cedartown and North Oconee, that one's tied at 7. Benedictine's put 21 on the board early at home at Savannah Memorial Stadium as they are leading Troop. That's Quad A's update.
AAA, we have Oconee County at Cedar Grove and Fellowship Christian versus Fitzgerald, and those two teams are playing for the first time ever.
Yep, and so AAA, when you're looking quickly, Carver, Atlanta, Sandy Creek, that one is at the battlefield. Remember, here in AAA, 3 teams from Region 5 going at it, and Cedar Grove and Oconee County. So once again, Region 5 should be going right here. So Carver, Atlanta, remember, Carver, Atlanta, Sandy Creek. Carver, Atlanta lost by 10 during the regular season, and those two teams met both at the track and at the 50.
safety. Somebody tried to plant a flag. That's a really tough way to start a game. Cedar Grove, Oconee County on the right-hand side. Region 5 dominating AAA.
I don't know if we have time for a double A, John. You
yes,
give
we
it?
Do.
Okay, go.
Fitzgerald was leading a Fellowship Christian early on. Applin County and Thompson, no score on that one. Next, single A.
You go, John.
All right, single
40
A.
Seconds.
Surprise me. Where are we going? What division in single A? Tell me where we're going, and I'll hit them both by the time we go. So single A, when we have either one in Division 1 and Division 2. Swainsboro was leading Erwe County in Division 1 early on. No score we had in Prince Avenue and St. Francis. So Division 2, really quickly, Bowdoin and Lincoln County. Bowdoin was down early. They're now leading. Johnson County and Sly. Sly's leading 14-0 after one. They head to the second. That's your brackets. Let's kick off.
Now that's how you do a really quick bracket show. It's Rome. It's Hughes. Next, right here on GPB.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Georgia, presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia, as we welcome you back to Lakewood Stadium for game two of our semifinal Football Friday in Georgia, the 6A semifinal, as the fourth-ranked Rome Wolves have come to town to take on the number one-ranked Langston Hughes Panthers. And good evening. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former Auburn Tigers All-American, NFL first-round draft pick, and 15-year pro Wayne Gandy. And Wayne, Rome is back in the semifinals for the first time since 2018. They won the state championship in 2017, obliterating opponents. I bring that up because this Langston Hughes team reminds me a lot of that Rome team. They have averaged 55 points per game. Rome's had a great season. Can they stop the Panthers?
Something is going to have to give tonight, Matt. When you look at Langston Hughes, they're able to score with anybody, and on the other side with Rome, only giving up a little over 8 points a game, something has to